boy. What's this? Paul Blur, wake your ass up, boy.
What's this?
Uncle King David, boy, wake your ass up, boy.
What'd you say, boy? Did your voice change, boy? Look at this, is the real fucking DB boy fucking tonight. Yeah, and buy some liquor, man, we gon' get wasted. Pop them bottles on them hoes and tell them bitch we made it. DB boy. Yeah, I wanna get 100 grand in singles. Stack them shits up just like Pringles, thanking God I'm single. Yeah, ready to mingle though. I'm tryna slam dunk, y'all tryna finger roll. You know that feeling, feeling, feeling like everything changing. Motherfucker! Feeling like you was instantly famous.
You guys are so dumb, you couldn't fuck a dead horse. That's how stupid you people are. You know what I'm saying?
Baby boy.
My new bitch Brazilian, she gorgeous. This new life that I'm living is hard to absorb. Never had that feeling when you pull up, they say who that? New school, blue black, drop top, push back. It's Ali, yeah, I knew that. Threw that hoe by 2 stacks. When I'm in the building, man on hoes, run a full flat. Trips to Puerto Rico, margaritas, burrito. Vacation with my people, we do this for our people. You know that feeling like you want a Super Bowl ring. No ball hall, man, I'm playing for the team, yeah.
Yeah, we do it for the whole team.
You know, why is that wall? Oh, he built that wall. I said, wow, he built that big wall. Uncle Angelo, too? Yeah, Uncle Angelo, too. We believed it.
This man never had a round, nobody. This man got balls of fucking steel.
Motherfucker!
Jerk him to the right.
Hey, I don't give a shit if everyone here goes to Marianne for 1,000 years. It's gonna be no fucking deal. No fucking deal.
I got thrills on my line, got $1 million house. We used to rot and cool, just sweat.
I had nothing to do with it. That would be retribution. Matter of the God Almighty. I'm Gandhi.
Are you out of your mind? Are you seriously out of your mind?
Dude, in all due respect for me, I didn't mean to call you dude.
What? Well, you don't say nothing, man. Sit the fuck down and shut up.
What kind of wife is splashing around on the waves and saying,
"Wee!"
Don't say that to my face. I'll crack you upside your head. You fucking punk. You shouldn't even be in here. Now I'm out. Have a nice night.
Motherfucker!
You know what? I'm not putting up with this. Angel, have a good life with these fucking idiots. Have a nice life, Angel. You went a long way in a couple of days.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
Oh, Angel, stop. Please, stop.
Motherfucker.
If you were here, I would smack you in your face and rip your tongue out of your fucking mouth. DB boy. What's up, everybody? Happy Wednesday. Shit. Welcome to another edition of Gunsmoke the Don Shit Show. I am your host, Gunsmoke the Don. And for the next 2 hours, we're going to be rocking out to some bullshit. Yeah. Just the way we like it. Everybody hit the like button on the way in, please. Pretty please, with sugar on top. Hit that like button. 45 people in here, I'll take it.
Shit. I want to thank Sven Larson. Thank you for starting off the show that way, brother. And Nightmare. Thank you, bro. I appreciate you. Thank you, fellas. Shout out to the West Coast. Shout out to Denmark. Shit. The real gangsters, y'all. All right, cut the music. Yeah, cut that music, boy. Enough of that music. Mickey Griggs in the house. What up? Sonny Money. It ain't shit, cuh. Kodak Black, I don't know about that. Your show, though, is fire. Thank you, Sonny Money. It's the jacket. OG Ruby's in the house. Good to see you. That's right. You tell him. Hit the like button, share this bullshit, comment, and subscribe. All that good stuff. Yeah. What up, Gary? What's up, Carlos? Brian Bozek. Don Vito Cassiofero. Good to see you. What up, William? All right, let me scroll all the way to the top. I think my baby. Oh, no. Farmer was the first one in here. All right. And Woke Joke Devado Eater. What's up? When will you do a survey on the wokeness? I already did. I did one a few days ago. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the wokest of them all? It was a poll between AOC, Bill de Blasio, Don Lemon, and who was the other one? Oh, Howard Stern. Howard Stern came in second place. He's pretty woke. AOC was number one with over 50% of the vote. So I already did a woke poll. And yeah, I don't know. Today's poll was about rock and roll. And you guys are like, what's up with Metallica, man? What about Nirvana? Like, hey, I said late 90s, damn it. Metallica's like late 80s, isn't it? And Nirvana's early 90s. You know, I said late 90s, damn it. And I'm pretty surprised to see Korn not doing so good. You guys don't like Korn, huh? You guys are choosing System of a Down. Some other bullshit. Limp Bizkit. I guess Limp Bizkit is, they were pretty big when they were out. Let's see how they're doing. Oh, Limp Bizkit is number one right now. System of a Down is number two, and then a far third is Korn. All right, we don't care about fourth place, boy. Sally Baby, Sven Larson, mother, what the fuck happened? Oh, no, hey, Sven, yeah, don't worry about it, brother. No, don't unsubscribe from his channel. Carlos already apologized for it. It wasn't his fault. You know, he's just friendly with a few scumbags in the community. That's all. You know, he didn't know that was going to happen. I didn't know either. So he can't control what the guy's going to say. You know, the guy's a dope addict, a weirdo. I don't know. He follows a schizophrenic around on YouTube. So that's not Carlos's fault for what his guest says. So no, don't unsubscribe. Carlos is a good guy. He already apologized to me the very next day about it. So it's all good. I would like for you to resubscribe to Carlos, please. I was in there to help support his channel and, show my support. I'd like for you to do that too. Weather report. It's rainy over there. Yeah, it's supposed to be rainy today, but it didn't rain. And thanks again for the support, brother, to make it up to you. Oh, you're the man, bro. Thank you. Rude Irish. Nah, no rumble today. I don't think so. You never know what you're going to get on here, though. What's up, Thorn Blades? Yeah, I was over there today by City Field. And I was by the junkyard over there. And I had a... They got like some shithole. I don't know. When they make food, I got myself a torta, a pollo torta. I had to get somebody to translate for me because the girls refused to take my order because they couldn't speak English. And then, yeah. They charged me ocho. They charged me $8 for the sandwich. I feel like I got ripped off. I feel like because I'm an American, they charged me extra. Because I'm not in the know, you know. I didn't speak no Espanol. Motherfucker. It's all good, though. That was a damn good sandwich. Probably the best sandwich I've ever had. Not ever had, but in a long time. Better than Subway, I'll tell you that much. Probably roaches and rats back there, too. The whole place is covered in dust. Look like shit. Right next to some chop shop. You know, some fucking hole-in-the-wall shithole, you know? They got some cute girls working there. I don't know. I might have to get me a little Mexicana wife, you know? They sure know how to cook. As long as they don't complain, that's all good, you know? I don't want to hear no fucking complaints. Just cook, all right? Wait a minute. That sounded sexist. I'm sorry. Anyway, what up, BX? Whee! That's right, boy. Nah, I was on the bidet earlier this morning. Don't you worry about it. Nah, let me scroll down. Shouts to William. Pizza's a trip. He's the president of the University of Insult and Slander. Yes, he is. He's good at that. He's the best. Johnny Lawrence. Johnny Lawrence? What the fuck? What up, man? What you doing, some Tai Chi, boy? Brian Bozek says, Smoke, do you know if Rob happened to hear what was said? No, I hope not. I hope not. I'm not telling him. I don't want you guys to tell him either. If he finds out on his own, he finds out on his own. But please, don't instigate nothing, because, you know, I don't think he meant to say that. Sometimes you get aggravated, you don't think, and you speak foolish. And that was a very foolish thing to say yesterday, so I don't know. I didn't hear from Rob, so maybe he don't know about it. So don't mention it to him. Let's just forget about it, all right? I don't want to see nothing happen to nobody. And let's just take it easy, huh? If he finds out on his own, that's his deal, you know? I want nothing to do with it. Ro-Ro baby, happy hump day, all you beautiful people. Yeah. What's up, Funhouse? Thanks for the support yesterday, Funhouse. I appreciate you, brother. My biscuit is limp right now also. Yeah. I was typing that in, you know, for the stupid poll, and I'm like, wait a minute. I never thought about that. Limp biscuit, you know? It entered my mind like, oh, wait, what? It's an odd name. When you're younger, you don't really think about that shit, but it dawned on me like, wait a minute. They all stink. Oh, I can't wait for Merlino's response tomorrow. Also, did you see this shit that Gene Borello had like an interview lined up with some British guy and he flaked on him? The guy even paid him for the interview. I don't know how much he paid him, but had to be a few hundred dollars, right? Had to be anywhere from $200 to $500, maybe. I don't know. The guy's a very small channel. I think he's got maybe 300 subs if he's lucky. I don't know, but seems like a nice guy. And I guess Gene Borello told him, hey, I got a new car. I can't do the interview. The guy's like, what about the interview? No interview. He's like, oh, you took my money. So he did a video about it. And he was like, you know, I was warned about this guy. People told me not to do the interview. Blah, 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 blah. I wanted to do it anyway. Because, you know, the guy does bring views. He's a popular guy. And so I guess Gene Borello heard about his video. So now he did a response video. So let me see if I could, because I didn't listen to it yet. So let's see what he had to say here.
Former mob associate Gene Borello responded to this YouTube video.
It's Jeff the Do. Shout out to Jeff the Do. I'm sorry to do. I didn't know it was yours, brother.
After he no-showed for an interview. Let's give a listen to his response.
Yeah.
I did him a favor for $100. I said, you know what? Don't worry about it.
Oh, 100.
You know why? Because the guy was like begging me. So then all of a sudden he sends me a link three times that don't work. Oh. I think he did it purposely because he wanted this to happen because he's looking for attention. But now he's getting in the wrong way because I'm going to get him blackballed from YouTube and everything else. So his mistake was doing that with me. You know, I spend more money on spilled liquor than this guy makes in his life. You know what I mean? I don't know where he came up with this story, but, you know, it's fine. But I know he wants the attention of me calling him out. You're a fucking UK clown. You probably sound like Austin Powers when you talk. You know, now you'll never get an interview from anyone.
I got to learn how to do these insults, like, off the cuff. These guys are good with these insults. They just come up with it right away. Like, you know, you're probably a UK clown. Sound like Austin Powers. You know, I spend more money on spilt liquor than you do in your wife. Whatever the fuck he said. So he paid him $100. That's, you know, no wonder he don't come around here no more. Thorn Blades. What's up, Thorn Blades? Root Irish, my dude. What up, Root? MR She sounds as unhinged as Danny Trio did about 2 years ago. MR She getting scared? That would be bizarre. The rat paperwork is coming. I hope so, man. I hope so. I really do. I really do. Let's see. What else we got here, boy? Who else is in the house today? Magilla Gorilla. He's going to rope up after tomorrow. Yeah, rope up. Let's go. Kick that stool from underneath you. Let's go. Yeah, it's going to be bad. I'm sure he's already having a nervous breakdown. Like, what's Joey going to say? Joey Merlino was my friend. Joey Merlino is my friend. You don't talk about Joey. Joey's very unhappy right now. He's my friend. The guys in Philly are very displeased right now. Carlo Gambino ran the mob. The Patriarca family. Patriarca, Patriarca, Patriarca. Yeah, I'm sure he's having a fucking nervous breakdown. Hopefully, you know, Joey has some entertaining stuff to say tomorrow. I'm looking forward to it. Is he going to do this live? I don't know. Does he go live? Or is it just going to be a video? I think a video would be more special, you know. Direct and to the point.
Oh, you know, Joey was my friend. Why would he say this? Oh, Angel, make it stop. Make it stop. Please call Joey. Somebody call Joey. Tell him to stop.
What else we got here, boy? What up, Sean? You've been gone for a week. What's the word? Oh, you missed a good show yesterday. If you've been gone for a week, you better go watch the replay, boy. Better recognize. Hope you had a good week, though, brother. Good to see you in here. JM619, my man. Good to see you. From Staten Island, B. Yeah, I feel you, dog. I didn't know Staten Island was so gangster. I guess it is. I don't know. It's the forgotten borough, you know? Real New Yorkers. We don't think about Staten Island, really. Might as well just give it to Jersey, but I guess they're gangster out there. I mean, there's gangsters everywhere, you know? Yeah, hit that like button, y'all. Thank you, OG Ruby. I'm at work. Boss right over my shoulder, but I'm listening. You're pushing it, huh? Don't get yourself fired now, girl. What up, Eric? Good to see you, bro. Eric in the house. Gene telling the story and how he's a killer now is pretty entertaining. Is he doing that? He's telling fairy tales like his new partner.
Yeah, so I took a baseball bat. And I just kept swinging and swinging. I got blood all over my new Gucci shoes. I was pissed off. I went home and found out the guy ended up dead.
I got so much money, man. I don't know. I don't fucking know. Where's my lighter now? God damn it. Son of a bitch. Hold on, man. God damn it. All right, hold on. Yeah, hold on. Pause, pause. There it is. Son of a bitch. That's a good point, Thornblades. Well, then, give them the money back. That's a good point. You got so much money, you don't give a shit. You wipe your ass with that, huh? That's a good point. Give them the money back. I didn't think about that part. That was the fucking cigarette. There we go. He's going to spike up, but then he's going to rope up. Spike up and rope up. A lot of sword fighting going on in the UK. They don't fuck around. Shit. Why would he pay for spilt liquor? I don't know. You know, he goes out to these wild parties. I don't know. God knows what they're doing down there. What do you call that shit? Swinging? They're probably swinging down there. Bunch of swingers, you know. Liquor gets spilt in the jacuzzi. Who the fuck knows what they're doing down there? Sick fucks. It's my blue heaven down there. Joey Franks. Gene still owes me an autographed book I paid already. God damn it. Well, I don't know what to tell you. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how you're going to get that autographed book. I don't know. Sean, Gene is another shitty girl. Oh, wow. Who caught every time he did something. Who got caught every time he did something. Then when he had it. God damn it. Why am I dyslexic? Then when he had to sit down for 5 years, he told. As Casper Rosa, he said he ran away because he burned that guy for $30,000. Is that why? I don't know. Casper Rosa. Yeah, I said his name three times real quick. So he might appear now. I think his ears start ringing like, what's my name? Who's live? What's up, Bob S? Good to see you. Tony Duck's in the house. I'll tell you what Merlino's going to say. Yeah, please enlighten me. What's he going to say? Can't wait. I'm dying to know. It sucks that he's making us wait 2 days. In the technology age, how hard could it be to get paperwork? I don't know. I guess it costs money and maybe these records are extra special, you know? Like, I don't fucking know. I don't look up people's paperwork. What the fuck do I know? But maybe it's extra special paperwork that it's hard to find, you know, the easy way. How, what the fuck? He's lying that he's getting death threats on Instagram. Is that what he's saying? Where did he say that? Now these guys are threatening me. Joey was my best friend. Now they're threatening to kill me. Who would do that? I don't know. I mean, there are sick people out there, but I mean, Joey didn't even really say nothing yet. If he starts getting threats with some guys in Philly, then I don't know. Then maybe he's got an issue there. I don't care what Molino says. He loved me. I used to get cheesesteak with him and drink coffee. He has no credibility. Not anymore. Whatever he had left, Jory Molino's about to step all over that shit. Whatever little bit of credibility he had left, that's going to be undone tomorrow. Single-handedly by Jory Molino. I guess it's, I don't know, maybe it's fate. It's ironic, you know?
He's my friend. I've known Joey for years. Joey doesn't like this. Joey doesn't like that. Joey.
I heard even Stacks is now dunking on him. That must suck. Damn. That's like throwing salt in the wound, man. That's like overkill now.
Yeah, man. Let me get in there, man. Hey, you suck, man. You lied. You lied, man. Hey, man. Hit the fucking like button, man.
Roman's been on the phone with his lawyer all day, probably. Probably, yeah. Trying to get in touch with his lawyers, trying to squash it. Like, you know, cease and desist. Do not use my name. Do not fucking use my face. I mean, Merlino's purposely not saying his name the correct way, so he's mispronouncing it. I don't know if that's on purpose or he's just really not familiar with the guy. I mean, he can't even say Longman or Canarsie. Joey used and abused him, I guess so. What's up, Hey Now? Good to see you. Hey Now. It's been a few episodes, brother. Hope you're doing all right. I kissed Joey on the cheeks every time I saw him. I almost got made. I was scrolling down. No more what? I heard him say the other day that he blocked her. What? So he can't see her comments and she can't see his. Really? Damn. I forgot why that was. Didn't she call him out the other day or a week or two ago? I think she called him out, him and Chicky. I don't know. It's none of my business. I don't want to end up on no fucking thumbnails tonight, but I forgot what he did. He did something. Okay. Yeah. He goes on a shithead show that she don't like. That's what it was. Okay. I remember now. Yeah, good. Fuck him. Good. Why would any stand-up guy hang with what? Yeah, it never made sense to me. I don't know. I thought maybe it could be true. You know, I try to give people the benefit of the doubt, but it always had me scratching my bald head. Like, I don't know, man. It don't feel right. Johnny Lawrence. It's always been full of bullshit. Some of his mob shows from years ago were from Wiki word for word. He did have some good shows back in the day, but not the mob stuff. Just when he was like complaining about trolls and some other people. I don't know. He would make threats and stuff. That was entertaining. He used to be real slick with his mouth. But I don't know. You know, I guess we all get old, huh? We lose our touch. Staten Island has a gangster on every other block. I heard that. Yeah. Hey, what the hell? What the hell's up with this name? I like the comment, though. He's pulling his hair out, rocking in the fetal position as we speak. What's up with that name, though? Jesus Christ, man. Well, motherfucker, what the fuck, man? 97 people in here. They're waiting for a guest to come on. Let me drop a link. I don't know. See if we get anybody on here who wants to curse me out or I don't know. Should I say BK Shaolin's name again and summon the fuckery?
Hey, you're talking out of your ass.
Hey, please come back, please. Had a great show yesterday. I got 94 people here waiting for the fuckery. The show starts off slow, but it picks up. I would never put money in the pocket of where or Johnny Light so they can continue spinning lies. They got to make a living somehow. I don't know. Jeff takes his stories from the websites. I could see that. I should have done that bullshit. You got to fake it to make it on here. All these fake it to make it. But then again, they get exposed, so it's not good to fake it to make it in certain aspects, you know? Oh. So what up?
Remember I told you, like, many months back, maybe a year ago? I don't know how long ago. It was all bullshit with this guy.
Yeah, you did. You told me that, yeah.
Well, here we go.
I'm looking forward to it tomorrow, man. I want to hear what
this guy is. I remember this guy told me a fucking story when I interviewed him years ago, right? Like in, I don't know, 2016 after he fell out with A-Light in the time since. There's some story that when he was with A-Light, he was with A-Light and another cooperator who I don't want to name here. He was with them in Atlantic City at the Borgata, right? And he was with them at the Borgata, right? But he was he told me this story that he was with them, like, at the table or whatever, like, talking, whatever, like, inside, like, I don't know, getting food or something in the casino. And he gets up to go to the bathroom. And who does he run into in the bathroom?
Narducci? I don't know.
Joey Merlino. And he has a conversation with him. And then he goes back to the table and sits, like, with A-Line. I'm just like, what? Bizarre fucking stories, bro.
Did he try to shake his hand, too?
I got to go back and review exactly what he said. I don't remember the details, but according to him, you know, he had a conversation. You know, he knows Joe and his friends. I don't know if it was, you know, just washing their hands. I don't know. But then he went. But then he went back. I got to review it. You know, it's, I got to review exactly what he told me. It's a crazy story.
So you think his career is over in the mafia genre?
He's not. He won't recover from this. He won't recover from what he already said on the Instagram post. He won't recover from.
Yeah. Oh, it was on Instagram? What did he say? Somebody said he said he's getting death threats or something?
No, I think Joe Perry called him like a freak or something, you know?
Joe Perry called him a freak?
Something to that effect. But I got so many stories. I remember I was at an after party for one of John III's fights, and it was in Connecticut. This is maybe like January 2020 or in this would have been in 2019, and it was an after party. It was in Hartford, and Johnny, I believe, he knocked this guy out or whatever, and then there was like an after party. It was like a little lounge. It was like a restaurant with like a little lounge type vibe though in the back, and I'm sitting there on one side of the room. It was like a small room, you know. It was like a small little lounge area with a group of people. And I don't know, 10, 15 feet away, maybe on the other side of the room, he's there with a couple of people and he's wearing a shirt that says "Stop glorifying rats." And I'm just sitting there like, how the fuck is this guy in this room right now? Like what is going on? You think Mob Tube's bizarre? That it was bizarre, man.
It's bizarre.
Yeah.
Very bizarre.
Yeah, he showed up in a "Stop glorifying rats" shirt.
That's some fanboy shit.
Yeah, it was just weird. He was just on the other side of the room, and I'm just like, it's like, what the hell is this?
Stop glorifying rats. Joey's my friend.
Well, I don't know. He did know him, you know, but it's like, you know.
Bob, remember that news footage from back in the day? That kid's like, he's my idol.
Remember that was that him when he was younger?
Yeah, that's what Bob S. says.
He was over there like, what cheese steaks? You know,
they're not gonna lock you up for this, will they?
What murders? What cheese murder? Steaks?
There was no cheese steaks. What up, Tanks?
You know, I would feel bad for the guy, but he's such a scumbag that just like, well, whatever. That's what you get. That's what you get for being a lying fraud. You know?
Yeah. I mean, I kind of feel bad for the guy too,
but then you remember like all the lies. Well, I had different experience with this guy. Just, you know what I'm saying? This guy went around lying about people. He went around lying about me for, you know, just like, and people will come to me asking me like I remember like Damien in probably late 2018 or whatever, you know, Damien and I had become friends, and I knew him before I knew Chicky. But, like, you know, I was getting to know these guys, and we were cool. And I remember him asking me, like, what's the deal with this guy Loman or whatever? Like, who is this guy? And you know, if you're friends with somebody and they ask you, like, basically, do you vouch for this guy? Like, who is this guy? Is this guy, is this an okay guy? Is he a scumbag? Is he a weirdo? Like, you know, you're not being a friend if you're not honest. That doesn't mean you have to include every little detail, but if you're not, like, generally honest, you're not being that person's friend. So I basically just told him, you know, the basics or whatever. But he's like, it's not like he was questioning me, but he was like, but I don't get this. If he lived with Eli, he's this kind of guy. Why is Angel like vouching for him? I don't understand this. And I don't have an answer for you, man. You know, yeah. Like, what do I say? So
yeah, what can you say?
And you know, people would get mad at me for just like speaking the truth. But I was just like, yo, if somebody comes up to me, like I was asked not to speak about this guy, but it's like. If somebody comes up to me, a friend asks me, what's the truth about this guy? What am I supposed to do? Be a mute? What am I supposed to lie to somebody who's my friend? You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Then what kind of friend am I? Like, I didn't tell this guy to go live with Eli. I didn't tell this guy to go lie about all of us and tell these crazy lies.
Yeah.
You know, this guy was calling her brother, like, things MRE's been accused of. Things like that, you know? And it's just like, it's like the craziest, most demented lies. And...
Well, this guy likes to sue people, so I got to be careful here. But I will say, in my personal opinion,
I absolve Gunsmoke of anything I say on the show. He doesn't. I'm not saying he knows this for a fact. I know this for a fact.
Yeah.
Sue me, cocksucker. You know?
No, but in my personal opinion, which I'm entitled to, yeah. I feel like he's got some mental illness there. He can't help it. He has to lie and make up these crazy stories. I think he's had a rough life, and
he's got some mental illness. You know, you don't just become a neo-Nazi. And you don't just...
No, not him. What you call him?
Yeah, and you don't just go on YouTube and create a persona that you were from the patriarchal family when you weren't, you know? Something went wrong in your life for that to happen, so...
Yeah. Now, he is a habitual liar.
Pathological.
Well, both, yeah. Habitual and pathological.
He's cut from the same cloth as Eli, you know? Just in a different way, so...
Habitual boy.
I remember in 2016. Like I didn't fucking know this guy. He's on there saying he was falsely accusing me and her brother of crimes, like just despicable, horrible crimes or whatever. And just like real, what are you talking about, dude? This is like what? Like what are you fucking where are you, like what? You're it's terrible.
Yeah. He's got some deep rooted issues there. Be my friend.
you want to hear a funny story? You got to ask Damien and Chicky what happened when he went to Springfield. That's a funny fucking story.
Oh, Jesus.
But you got to hear it from them. Like I could never tell. Like you know the way. I'll put it like this.
I know Chicky could tell it good.
Yeah. You probably have to have the three of us on the phone or whatever to really just explain this whole situation. But there's so many different factors that go into the story, but I'll just say this. This guy was brought somewhere, and the guy thought he wasn't the right guy because people like Angel vouch for him, you know?
Yeah.
And I forget how, but I end up on the phone with this guy while this guy's in the next room. And he's telling me he's there, and I'm just like, yo, you know, like, this guy lived like, with Eli and everything, right? And he's like, no, I didn't know that. What are you talking about? And I'm explaining the story. He's like, I didn't know any of this shit. He's in my house right now. What the fuck is this? I was like, yo.
Wait, I think I heard that story.
I'll tell you certain things privately, but yeah. Without mentioning people's names or whatever. But like, you'd have to have me, Damien, and Chicky all on the line at the same time. It's a funny fucking story what happened out there. So
yeah, the guy's a character.
Like, I mean, I wasn't there, but I was on the phone, you know? as this crazy fucking set of circumstances was unraveling in Springfield, Massachusetts.
Jesus. What's up, Chad D?
I remember, like, in 2016, when this guy first popped up on YouTube, Facebook, whatever, I was at John's office one day, and we're talking. I'm just sitting there talking, and I'm telling him about this guy that popped up on Facebook and everything. And I was like, yeah, you know, this guy says he's you know, his grandfather was like Great Patriarch's driver, or it may have been his uncle. You know, I don't know if the story switched to when it's, you know, whatever, something to that effect, his grandfather, great uncle, whatever. And John looks at me, he's like, well, maybe he was. And I was just like, no, trust me, he wasn't. But because he didn't know what this guy was, just some character I was telling him about.
Yeah. He's a lunatic. He thinks he's in the mob. What's up, Bag of Donuts? Yeah. I mean, I always thought, I don't know, I took his word for it that he was affiliated. I don't know. I don't know why I fucking believe that, but.
You live and you learn, you know?
Yeah.
Chances are, if somebody's affiliated, they're not going to go on YouTube and say, hey, you know, I just had coffee with this guy. Right?
That's why it never made sense to me. It always left me scratching my head like, I don't know. It's like,
are
weird
these people okay with you telling all their personal business on YouTube?
I always thought about that, yeah.
Because it doesn't have to be an accused mob figure, accused street figure. It could be your friend who's an electrician, your friend who paints houses, your friend who's, you know, a cardiologist, whatever. It's like, you think they're going to be okay with you just going on YouTube and telling all their personal business or whatever? It's like, it's crazy. It's like, who would do that?
Yeah. Marky says, so he was ratting on you and her brother, basically. Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, no, he tried to frame us for crimes. Me specifically. Wow. To dirty her brother by extension, really. Well, when I say really, I mean, that was part of it. You know, there were forces trying to get me locked up. Not that I was, I'm looking for the right words, but a big element of that was to dirty her brother by extension, because I was working with him.
But then after that, didn't a certain someone help him out when he was homeless? And
yeah, when he fell out with a bite or whatever, he reaches out to me one night. This is July 2000.
Which is crazy.
He reaches out to me from like a different number or whatever. And he's scared for his life, all this crazy shit. And I interviewed him that night. And long story short, you know, Angel and Elio basically took him in. Now, you want to make peace with somebody? All right, whatever. You accepted an apology.
Yeah.
You know, he gave you information about A-Light, what was going on over there. Okay, whatever. You want to make peace. You want to just, whatever, you know, teach his own. But to just, like, take him in and then vouch for him as, like, a stand-up guy and everything, like what? Like, what do you not remember all the shit this guy, like, how can you, that's, and I was always so uncomfortable with that. And it caused tension, because it was just, like, it was, and, you know, there's things I could have done better, but it caused tension, because it was, like, again, you want to be diplomatic, you want to make peace, all that's fine, but I'm not going to vouch for the guy, you know?
Yeah.
But it is what it is. Yeah.
Oh, I remember that too, Joe Bag of Donuts. That guy, he was calling Joe Bag of Donuts a cop or something about his kid. I don't know. Weird shit. What's up, Tevin Ace Boy? Anthony Tevin Ace in the house, my man. Nobody should blame Wham for anything. She's not in the wrong at all.
That's not true. She lied to cover for him. She vouched for him and everything, and she gave credibility to somebody she shouldn't have. Is she responsible for lies that he's told? No, but she like vouched for him as like a credible person. She publicly lied that he never lived with A-Light. And when you do things like that, you could instead just not comment, just refuse to comment. But when you go out there and you lie for somebody like that, it puts other people are going to question people who tell the truth about certain things that occurred, like myself or Damien or whoever. But Damien, you know, Damien and Chicken, they had their own experiences with this guy. The entire cast of that TV show that he was doing had their fucking crazy experiences with this guy. But it's when you do something like, it's like if somebody's a total piece of shit or whatever, and I go out there and I tell all my friends, hey, he's a good guy, you can trust him, whatever. And then he fucks these people over. You bear some responsibility in that, because it's like you lied to your friends to cover for this guy, you know?
Yeah.
But it is what it is, you know? It's, what are you going to do?
So much for the Flanagans, huh?
Dude, but it's all, you know, there's things I could have done a little better with all that, but, but it caused tension, because this guy, like, I would catch this guy lying about me. Well, I didn't want to get into it. I'll get into it at a later date. There's a lot of stuff that went on.
Didn't he like just like have a tantrum one day and like say, you know, fuck this? He stopped filming and he left Damien to fucking be director.
That's what I heard, because Chicky would call me like periodically, like throughout the day, and give me updates from the set and everything, you know. And he's like, yeah, so get this. I was like, what? He's like, yeah, Damien's now the director of the Flanagans. I was like, what do you mean? He's like, yeah, well, Jeff just disappeared, so Damien took over, you know, because we can't find Jeff, you know. So
yeah,
all right, yeah, he like left. According to the people who I wasn't there, but according to the people who were there, he just like he was supposed to be in a scene, you know, and he just like left. He just like, you know, left the filming location. Like, where'd he go?
Oh, he also said he got shot twice. They're saying that now. Is that true? He said he got shot twice on two different occasions?
I have no knowledge of that.
What about the picture with blood on his face? Was that real blood? Or
I wasn't there, but it does look like ketchup.
It does.
But I wasn't there. You know, I don't know.
What's up there, Heinz boy? Doug Jack, what up, man? I don't know, these guys in the chat, they really don't like this guy. I think they see through his bullshit, huh?
Well, you know what it is? It's
he's talented. I always show them respect.
Look,
yeah,
he's talented with the radio stuff. He is. And I don't he should just look, hindsight is 20/20, right? But you want to go tell, like, I would remember telling this guy in like 2016, 2017, 2018. I don't remember exactly when, but I told this guy numerous occasions. You should write a screenplay, you know, write a book, write a screenplay, something, because you could probably, there's probably, because you're sick and twisted, but I wasn't trying to insult him. I was like, yo, you're demented, dude, but like, you have a mind that would probably come up with some demented screenplay that's fucking awesome. You know, yeah. Like, you know, like I was, dude, you probably have an awesome fucking screenplay inside of you. And from what I understand, the Flanagans was actually a really good script. I never read it. I didn't want to read it. It was offered to me to read it by somebody with a copy of it, but I was just like, I don't want nothing to do with that script, because were I to read that script, you know, this is the kind of guy who would sue me 10 years from now for stealing material from it when I did no such thing. I don't even want to know about that script, but I heard it was really good. Yeah. So.
Yeah. Well, he's very creative.
Yeah, no, I heard it was great.
And, you know, and
he had a good little cast together. You know, they could have really filmed like a really good independent pilot. And, you know, he had a good little crew together, you know?
Yeah.
So it's I heard stories that I was not there, but I heard stories that, you know, he like robbed people for money, like money he was supposed to go to the show, but he pocketed it, things like that, lied to people, tried to turn people against each other, all this crazy shit. And well, it was a good opportunity that was blown.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I was always nice and respectful to the guy. One night he just trashed me out of nowhere, and it wasn't the same after that.
Yeah, then the next thing, you know, his paperwork went up. So I didn't like that, man. You're a nice guy. I didn't like that. I had enough of this whole shit.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, I remember that. You stood up for me. I appreciate you, brother.
No, I didn't like that. I've seen him do this shit to people for years. Like, dude, and the reason why I ended up in possession of that paperwork is because in 2018... he was fucking lying about me to Angel, and I pointed it out. I was like, this is a lie. And there were a couple things that happened, but I was just insulted. I was like, you know what? I know this guy's a fucking rat somewhere. I'm going to fucking find it. I just, sometimes you just know people, you know? But you just have to, like, and I was able to find that paperwork, you know? That's all I could say. And, you know, certain people have known about it since 2018. So you claim to hate rats? But you're platforming a fucking rat, you know? So, yeah. And lying that he's not a rat. Like, here's the fucking information. What are you talking about?
Yeah. And there was some story about cooperating over stolen DVDs or something like that. I don't know.
You want me to send you the images? You can put them up.
You've got images? I don't know. It's
on my community page. It's, you know, I posted, I don't know, might be like 10 posts back or something.
Yeah.
I mean, I could just send it to you like in a message.
Send it over. Let's take a look at it.
All right, drop the link because I'm gonna sign over. I'm gonna message it to you and I'll come back on.
All right,
thanks.
All right, yeah, I think Marky Mark wants to come on, and I think JC wanted to come on. Sorry about that. Ryan, £1.99 British pounds. Thank you, my friend. Love you too, brother. Super sticker style. Yeah, thank you, bro. Templar, fuck them good. Keep fucking that chicken. Yeah. What did Loman do? Why are people saying he is done in the genre? Well, he lied about being friends with Joy Molino, and now Joy Molino's calling him out on it, and I don't know what sparked it. I really don't follow either of them, really, so I don't know how it started, but here's Jay Shee, my buddy.
Buddy, hang on. Let me turn up the chat on the cell phone. Yeah. I'll just keep the chat on my TV so that anybody I have blocked, I don't see. Hey, Mark, what's up, bro? There's no reason to be hating on you. You're a stand-up guy out here. Freaking 100%, you got a good rep. Go ahead, man.
Hey, I just wanted to make a quick analogy. Real fast, Casperosa said something that sparked a thought in my head. A lot of people, there's a dude, one of the homies, Sean, he's from Cali. He, you know, me and him had conversations about Jeff Canarsie. Not that it means anything, but the dude Canarsie has, you know, pulled the wool over some people's eyes. They thought he wasn't capping. That dude's all fucking cap, bro. He's nothing but a fucking bullshitter. And I told people, like, listen, you got to understand, you know, I've said 1,000 times, I don't even care to say it anymore, but it's like, you know, when a dog smells a female and or a wolf smells sheep, you know, they're going to go for the kill. Listen, when you've been around nothing but killers your whole fucking life, you've been in the joint, you start to be able to read these things, right? It's kind of like if there's somebody that's claiming he's a plumber, okay, and he's talking to another guy that's an actual plumber, and the one dude's lying, and he's going, as soon as that guy starts lying about what he's doing for a living, the guy who's an actual plumber knows immediately, this guy's full of shit. Now, he may call him out. He might not say nothing. He just doesn't give a fuck, right? But that's how you can, you know, pick up on things that this guy's a real street guy. Knows this guy's full of shit. Now, people say that he's got talent. Yeah, he might have talent. He's a good editor and all that. He should just go that route. He should have just did that. He took a false persona and ran with it, and he's got himself in trouble now. You know, he should have stopped while he was ahead and just held back on the bullshit. Now look, what are his choices? He's either got to go away and disappear, because what's going to happen is a guy like Joey, he's got his own platform and channel now. Listen, if this dude Canarsie tries to, you know, rebut anything this guy's saying, these people are just going to make him look worse than he already does.
This is the only good option for him. If, in my opinion, he needs to drop all his bullshit, be brutally honest about creating this fake persona, it was all bullshit, everything, and write like a script or a book or make something like a short film, a little movie, an independent movie that's fucking brilliant that eclipses all of it.
I'd say he should just apologize for everything and bounce out and then do something else.
Well, yeah,
I think he needs a therapist.
Admit the bullshit.
He needs a therapist. He needs to come out and say, I have severe mental illness. Yeah. I personified something I wasn't, and write a book about that. You know,
no shit,
that'd be interesting.
Well, he has to know about some other topics besides this. Look, he ain't even that great with mob info. Because look,
he's terrible.
Ago, he said that Gambino and freaking no, Bonanno and Carmine Galante had issues. That's bullshit. Fucking Galante was in prison when Bonanno got chased, and he was mad and sought revenge when he got out of prison. They were great friends, and he said, "Oh, Bonanno got chased by Galante." That's not even close to being true. So
the dude
needs to
bro.
Bounce out and say sorry to everybody, and then do something else later.
Tony Pizza has the same illness Jeff got. Tony Pizza's a trip, bro. That Eagles on it just fucking from the first minute he opens it, it's nothing but it's funny, but he just lies from beginning to end. It's fucking wild,
at least,
man.
He makes money from it. Pizza can sort of say, hey, it works for him, and you know,
I've been saying this. If Tony Pizza had just had somebody helping him, like a manager of sorts, which could be anything,
for real,
like, you know,
no
just,
shit,
just a regular person. That gets set up like a website for him or something, like a Rumble account or whatever. He could easily be making like 200 G's a year.
Bro, 150, 200 pizza could easy. Be wealthy if easy. Someone exactly. manages money. Yeah.
Yeah. I know, but I mean, imagine like his online presence, you know, and like, you know, how brand it and everything.
Yep. If he had the right people, the right marketing team, and the right manager around him, he could make some. Yeah, definitely.
There's a lot of sick people in this world who would pay $10 a month to watch this guy make racial slurs and say the craziest things about people. There's a lot of people who pay money for that.
He's funny in his own way. It's like hearing any homeless dude on the street corner saying shit, except he's online and pizza does.
He just fucking lies, bro. It's wild as fuck. As soon as you wind him up, let him go, it's just lies from fucking the second he opens his mouth to the end. It's fucking crazy. It's funny, though. But as far as Canarsie, it's like, yo, dude, the guy don't want to be your fuck. Even if you were friends with the guy, like, and you were as close as you said, look, the guy don't want to be your fucking friend anymore. Let it go, dude. Fuck it, you know?
Yeah.
That's what it is. Move on, man.
Bro, he should not fight with Merlino at all. That I agree with you, Mark. He's going to get really wrecked.
Listen, the whole Flanagan thing, he ruined that shit completely by harassing women, taking money. Like, he is the core issue that show.
Yeah, he's just socially awkward, bro. He don't know how to fucking socially handle situations. He's like an extreme socially awkward human, bro.
I'll say this, right? When he was putting that show together in the beginning, that pilot together, I should say, Damien and Chicky, you know, I'd become friends with them and everything, and they hit me up, or one of them, or Damien, or the two of them together hit me up. I think it was like a three-way call. I don't remember. And they're like, listen, you know, Jeff, because we had like done some short films and stuff and put it up, and people like responded really well to it, just like some improv.
The script
stuff
was really good.
That's what I hear.
Not like Chicky and Damien's script. That shit was terrible.
There was no script. We were just filming improv stuff, and they're talented actors. And Damien actually wrote a script called Hungry Hill. That's what I'm talking about.
Hungry Hill was fucking terrible.
No, you're wrong in that, because, and I'm gonna tell you why.
I don't know.
No, you're wrong, because I read the first draft of it, right?
So did I.
I read the first draft of it, and if a seasoned writer had written that, I would be like, this is like trash. Like, what is this? It was all formatted wrong and everything. But for somebody who had never written a script before, right, and is not a literary person at all, I was like, yo, there's real fucking potential in this, because it's coming from a guy who he wrote that shit like on his phone. You know what I mean? Like in the app on his phone. It wasn't like in front of a computer. You know?
Potential, but dude, the script was just, I don't know.
But that's out of context. You got to remember, this is coming from a guy who's never written a screenplay, and there was good stuff in that. Was the whole script like complete? No, but there was really good stuff in there. Like, this could really become something. I was like, wow, this is, you know, there's really something here. You got a talent for this.
I haven't read it, but I made up a Damien the other day, so I won't say anything bad about him.
No, but real quick though, so I get a call from the two of them, or just him, I don't remember. I believe it was the two of them, and they're like, yeah, you know, Jeff, because we had put up these little short films, just improv stuff. There was no script. It was just like freestyling, like acting or whatever. And they're like, yeah, you know, Jeff offered us like a role in this or whatever, roles in this pilot. Are you okay with that? Because they were like being loyal to me. Like, you know, if you don't want us to do it, we won't do it. You know, fuck this guy, whatever. And I was like, no, go do it. You know, it could be a good opportunity. You don't know. Like that, even if the show sucks, if you have just like a good scene that's like professionally shot and everything, you could use that to get work in other projects. I was like, no, go do it. You know, but don't believe anything this guy tells you and anything he says about me. Check with me first, whatever, because he's a sick liar. And, you know, but I said to him too, I was like, you know, I was like, you know what this is, right? He's offering you roles, not because you're talented. That's part of it. But because he thinks it's going to make me jealous in some way or fuck with me. I was like, no, go fucking do it, bro. Knock it out of the park. Go do it. That's what I said. So,
straight up.
It could be a good opportunity. You don't know. It might become something. Who knows?
Loman for
the guy, if you know, I don't know what he's planning on doing, but if he's like really like pestering real dudes from the streets, I don't know too many cats from Philly, but I couldn't imagine that shit would go well for him, you know.
Oh, that was the other thing too. Damien says, listen, is this true what Jeff said? I was like, what's that? This is like right when he was trying to put it together. He said, yeah, he said Joe Armelino put up $500,000 to shoot the pilot. I was like, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, that kind of a lie.
No way.
That guy ain't giving a fucking $100 to nobody, bro. That's just going to the cap.
He ain't giving 500 cents.
No. But if it was a good project, even if he wasn't picking up the money himself, he could probably introduce you to a financier. You know, but that, what I was being told about what that show was, I was like, no, this is bullshit. Like, but you know, if it was something right. else, maybe he would help arrange financing for something.
That's
you know?
Just his way to try to say he knows people. You know what I mean? Connect himself to somebody.
You know what? Fucking if Loman weird. Had been smart with his lies, he would have understood that the Youngstown, Ohio mob was the guys who had West Virginia, technically, Pittsburgh. In Virginia. And if well, he Pittsburgh had lied,
you see, lying never ends well, yeah. man. Yeah, lies, no matter
but it would have been better than freaking Rhode Island.
Yeah, it's like, you know, like Chris said, the guy's got one or two opportunities to make shit, you know, and I think from the shit I've heard him talk about that he relies on them. He relies on YouTube and content for a living, bro. Now, you know, God forbid the guy ends up homeless and stops making money, but yeah. that's what happens when you get yeah. yourself fucking jammed up in stupid
whatever
bullshit.
Happened to his super we're
always a situation. Bullshit. Boy.
Nobody paid for his shit.
Yo, Frank you already know? Did a 60 Minutes expose on fucking Loman.
Yo, I gotta jump off, but have a good night, everyone.
All right.
You too, brother. All right. Thanks for coming on the show, man.
All right, peace. Thank
Thanks,
for having
bro.
Me. Peace.
And shout outs to NCO7. Thank you for the support, bro. Good to see you in here.
Freaking blow, man. That's some funny
shout
shit.
Shout outs to NCO7, my man.
He's lucky that he people have been generous and nice to him, you know, because things you do that type of shit, it can go wrong real fast.
You think they were nice or they just pitied him and were like, oh man, this dude's slow. There's something wrong
probably
with this
both. Guy. Probably both. He need that he look, you can tell the dude needs some toughening up, you know. That's a therapist field day for
bro,
a therapist.
He got shot and survived the house fire.
Yeah, what a squirt gun. I know it's crazy. Yeah. It's fucking crazy. You know, if that was the case, don't you think the dude would? I mean, come on, you know, show your hospital shit, dude. Why are you lying about this shit? This shit is weird.
Can't help himself.
In a fucking investigation, you know, on when those types of things happen, that's serious shit, man. You show up at a hospital with a gunshot wound, bro. The cops are gonna be all over that shit.
Yeah, no doubt.
There were two separate shootings, though, right?
Yeah,
of course.
Lee did drive by with his airsoft.
What's up, dude? What's up now, dude?
Hey, he should join the Reddit because that's all shit that you got to make up, anyways. And he could have, you know, he needs to go join Lee.
You know, I've never seen nothing like it. Yeah, he is because I've never experienced nothing like that. You know, seen any type of shit like that. It's fucking way out shit. I can't even
lie about the mob, dude. That's freaking around for like Merlino. I mean, lying about that.
Because he was counting on fucking this dude never saying anything, but the fact that he mentions the guy and he's like, yeah, you know, he's my buddy old pal. He's like, no fucking way. I can't have this dude fucking, no way.
Bro, he's tried to say, yeah, I got a text from you know who right now in the middle of his show. Like Merlino's texting him in the show, telling him what to say.
It's his whole like life of who he's made up, who he is for like credibility on the show to try to get people, I guess, to sub and purchase a Patreon. Whatever he's doing, right, was based around that guy, right? So now that guy is like, fuck, no, I don't fuck with this dude at all on any type of level. Yeah, he was. He came to my files and helped out, like kept it real. You know, told the truth. It's just gonna destroy this guy because of the lie he told him surrounding it.
Yeah, I got a feeling he's gonna try to pull the old Merlino is downplaying our relationship. Merlino and I were bros. He's just big time now, and he's leaving me behind. And he's gonna try that guilt trip, and you know, I'm being abandoned bullshit. You watch.
But listen, bro, this guy is gonna make this fucking, if this kid fucks with him and tries to say some shit like that, that's not true. These people are gonna make him look stupider than he already does.
Yeah. I agree with you there. They're gonna make him look even worse, but I think he's gonna try it, you know.
Yeah, I think he's that stupid.
You know, if he was smart, he would just say sorry for all of it and then say, hey, look, I gotta go get some help, blah blah blah. I'm gonna shut down my channel for now. And then maybe later he could come back doing something else that's more along his style. And he might get acceptance from people for that because people still like it when people apologize for stuff. You know, that's, you know, Bill Clinton back in the day, you know, a lot of people said, fight that shit. He said, no, I'll just apologize at one point and admit I lied, whatever. And America loved it. And, you know, but if he tries to keep it going and fight with Merlino over this shit, Merlino's just going to humiliate him even worse. That's how I see it.
Yo, he needs Merlino's protection, man. Puff Daddy's on his ass for fucking stealing that sport jacket from fucking Nobody Can Hold Me Down video.
I think he's a bitch. I think he's the biggest cock-sucking little bitch probably in the genre. I mean, there's a few of them, but he's ranked. Yeah. He's top three for sure.
Yeah, I guarantee his comment section is going to get closed off again.
Yeah, he turns that shit off.
Oh, yeah, he's going to be turning that shit off real soon. It took him about 10 years.
I'm picking up the kid from school. I got to jump off, yeah. But I'll be watching. I'll talk to you guys in a little bit.
All right, bro.
Bye, Mark. Enjoy.
Yeah. As soon as he picked up his little brave pills to, you know, allow comments and show his face, now this shit happens. So.
Yep, that comment section's closing right back up.
Bro. Yeah, that shit's going to be crazy by tomorrow if it's not already.
He's going to be like... You know how he's going to be, bro. He's going to freaking be like, let me start up by saying, you know, I did so much for this guy.
Yeah.
And, you know, I literally risked my life and, you know, and I went into the court and he's going to try to guilt trip and try to freaking, you know, act like Merlino is like ditching him and being the mean guy. And, you know, this is what I get for helping people and nobody's going to buy it. But
oh, wait, Merlino already talked about this on his Patreon today? Fuck, man.
No, it's going to be Thursday, I thought, tomorrow, right? Well,
I guess he does it live. I guess he does it on his Patreon a day early.
Oh, so gotcha.
The exclusive. Fuck, man.
He said he's doing it tomorrow, though. He said on Instagram, him and Snuff said, wait till Thursday comes around, and he called Canarsie a crackhead or something, and... and said, yeah, I knew him, but now I don't want to get to know him. Something like that, you know? And Merlino, yeah, bro, that's just a bad freaking thing for him. Best thing Canarsie could do is just apologize and say, all right, you guys, I got way too caught up in this stuff. And, you know, I need to go get some help. And I'm going to be away for a while. And then just delete his shit and bounce out for...
Okay. Did he really do that? Did he really go to Merlino's courthouse and talk about tell the reporters off, like, leave Joey alone. He's an average guy. Leave him alone. He deserves his privacy.
Oh, well, it's like that one dude, we won't say his name, but he talks about how he was blasting dudes and pulling triggers in his hometown and never got arrested for that stuff. And, you know, the one guy we don't talk about. But these guys freaking, when they do that stuff, they're saying that they're involving themselves in stuff that could not happen without police investigations. And then when there's no investigation, when it's like, hey, you just said something that we could rule out. There's like zero possibility here.
People saying shit like
that's
that.
That's what he did with Merlino, bro.
Built like that.
You know, he fuck, yeah. Bro. He yeah, exactly. Left no shit. He you know, but Merlino, you know, he's lying about a dude that's alive, and Merlino ain't no joke. Merlino's not some dude. Now, obviously, he's watched by the feds, so he's not going to go smack him up for it, but he is going to verbally smack him up for it. And, you know,
smack
again,
my bitch up.
You know, saying that shit about a dude that's living, that's, you know, that's on social media. He may not have been on YouTube this whole time, but he was on IG, and, you know, he's going to hear about it. And whatever, not gonna be good, guys.
They're telling some crazy A-Light stories. Fucking, you know, when Canarsie slept over his house and all that weird shit with the edge of the bed and all that.
Well, see, that's what? Another thing, too, bro. Is like when he first said Merlino liked him, I didn't believe it either because I'm like, A-Light, anyone who associates with A-Light, and this I'm included too here. I would never be accepted by Merlino, never, nor would I ever try to. I wouldn't even insult his intelligence by trying to be his bro. You know, he doesn't rock with anybody who says hello to snitches and informants. It's the way it is. You know, and for him to act like everybody would just fall for that shit when we all know Merlino's policy on that just shows that he really does have some of those issues, you know, upstairs. And he does not care that the bullshit he says is easily disproved. And whatever, you know, it's...
Oh, boy, was rocking a pearl pinky ring.
Yeah.
Fucking, oh, God, dude, that outfit, man.
Yeah,
he just sizes too big and shit.
Bro, you know it's bad when Stax is dunking on him, dude. Stax is dropping videos about him.
Oh, jeez.
Fucking Stax is doing 360 dunks right now on his
ass. Yeah, but the only person Stax is talking to is his reflection. So
let me see.
Fucking, and today we're gonna talk about Canarsie.
Canarsie, man. You suck, man.
Well, man, I thought you were the mafia guy.
Yo,
man.
Someone said some funny shit in my chat last night. They're like, I think it was Ishmael. He's like, yo, Stax looks like one of those fucking like dummies, like, you know, the ventriloquist dummies from like Goosebumps or some shit.
Hey, holy shit. He got 916 views in almost 4 hours. How
well, that's
fuck?
Because he threw Merlino's name is in the title. So, yeah, he did get some views off of it.
I'm going to have to start putting this guy's name in the fucking title every show now.
No shit, bro. Throw Merlino's name in the title. It'll work. It will double the hit count.
Hold on.
Afternoon chat about Merlino. There you go. Throw that in.
Yeah. My new guest. Hold on. I gotta see this shit. Hold on.
No, it works. That's not bullshit. Well, you know, it's why.
Stay on top of your finances.
If Stax can get up to 500 views,
yeah. Too bad they turn on the channel and they hear me, man, and they instantly turn it off.
All right, hold on. I listened to one of his parts on it, and he was capping on fucking Canarsie bad.
Bro, that guy has no business. Look at my fucking community page. I looked up like goofy white wannabe gangsters. Homeboy is number 7 on that list. I'm not fucking around.
Yeah, he platforms Raimundi. He ain't got no business calling people out.
No. All right, hold on.
Skinny Joe Merlino, we just filmed episode 32 with Adam and Ro. Another great episode we did. But you're going to find that full episode on YouTube and Patreon. But for what we're about to talk about right now, you have to head on over to Patreon.
Fuck your Patreon,
hit that
boy.
Subscribe button. You know what you got to do. The link's in all our bios. Because we got to talk about this freak, Jeff Canarsie. What's going on with this?
Here's the story about this fucking
We would like to thank.
Oh, that's gonna be good. He's like, here's a story about this fucking idiot, and that's like the little teaser. Oh, that's gonna be good,
bro. They were playing not them, but one of the other shows played that clip from Gene from like 3 years ago where he called him a Hills Have Eyes mutant or some shit.
No, they better strap him to the bed now. I mean,
he needs to get off of YouTube and stay away and not read any comments for a while. It's going to be bad.
At least take a break for a month.
You know, do any negative shit to himself like that.
Maybe in a month, you know, this will all blow over, you know, but he needs time to step away.
Yeah. Yeah. He needs
people forget about it.
He needs to go check into a facility for a minute and, you know, and they need to change his password to his YouTube.
Someone needs to 5150 that dude.
Yeah, he definitely he's gonna have a nervous breakdown. I mean, he almost had a nervous breakdown with me and Frank, and we weren't even doing nothing really crazy. I can only imagine with fucking Joey Merlino. I mean, it's gonna be bad.
Oh, I'm sure he's gonna be brutal with it.
Oh man, yeah, Merlino ain't, and Merlino's one of those dudes. He doesn't have to do a big old long show about anybody. He's one of those guys that can do like a 5-minute thing and just wreck a motherfucker with that. And yeah, it ain't going to be pretty. He's going to get right to the point and he's going to freaking, you know, him and Snuff are going to be like, all right, here's the deal with it. And they're pretty much probably going to say he inserted himself into the case thing. And yes, he was helpful for, you know, that time. We appreciated it. However, he decided to freaking turn Joey into his imaginary best friend. They're gonna cap.
I don't even know this guy. I saw him at the casino in the bathroom, and he offered to shake, and it wasn't my hand.
I like how they called him the freak. Let's talk about this freak. What do you think about him, Joey? Yeah, let's talk about this scumbag.
Oh Jesus!
Yeah, it's gonna be tomorrow's gonna be a fun day. Rocco, what's up, Rocco? Oh God damn it!
Nah, it's all good with what I did on my show on the soft white one.
Fuck.
I just went through, and Lefty knows this, I went through real quick to all the trolls, especially MRC, and I'm like, bro, 100,000 views on this video, yet you could only get 20 likes on your troll comment. And I hit Angela, you know, the right wing jock. I'm like, you got 15, and I did that to most of the trolls, you know, and then I went through and deleted it all, though. Lefty was like, delete that shit as quick as possible. And I'm like, yeah, good advice. You know, I was going to delete them anyways, but I was going to leave them up for a week or two, and Lefty's like, get rid of them as quick as possible. I made my point. You know, I just wanted to laugh at MRE in particular because he loves to – he's another one. Like, you know, he's worse than Canarsie. He fucking elevates his freaking stature in his own mind, believes he has this power. And the fact that a video with 100,000-plus views and he writes 4 or 5 hater comments and nobody pays attention to it, not even his own trolls, like 15, 20 likes. He's got more troll friends than that. They didn't even like his shit. I had to freaking throw it in there and just cap on him a few times, but Lefty sent me a text saying, don't do that because, you know, even though he looks like a fool, you're going to look like you're answering him. And I'm like, you know what? Good point. And so I went through and deleted those. But the fact is, bro, that they have lost their power. 2024 is the year. Like Cat Williams said that, you know, about Diddy and all them, that all the liars shall be exposed or whatever. Well, this is the year in this genre that all the clowns are going to lose. You know, MRE losing. Nobody gives a shit. He can't even pass 1,500 views on a video. And the dude's been doing this, once a week, maybe more, for 4 or 5 years. So the algorithm is in his favor as far as consistency. It's not like he hasn't done videos and he just does one out of nowhere. He's doing this shit all the time. Nobody watches. Everybody else that was a liar along with him, the idiots that believed the memes bullshit that they put out, the idiots that believed that Casparosa was some stalker when he's not, all these guys that believe the bullshit, look at them. They're failing, bro. They're failing big time. Even some of the guys that used to be our so-called friends, the three of us up here, we all know one or two guys that, you know, acted like they were some big shot and, you know, they were Nino Brown. And they get a bloody nose, they go crying. Yeah. It's the year of them to lose, bro. They are losing. And 2024, like Kat said, but it applies with us, shall be the year of exposure. And it's happening. We are winning. Lefty, you're a winner. I'm a winner. Gunsmoke's a winner. There's a few others, too.
I'm trying.
Brian, he's doing good, man. His books are already, it's coming out soon. It's already ordered pre-orders.
God damn it, Jack.
Hey, Marky Mark, you did good too. You freaking, and you've been very patient, by the way, with these fools. Like, I didn't listen. I don't listen to, you know, who's show because I can't stand her voice. But from what I heard, and then what I did watch, you know, Chris on the I Want to Talk Guy show. And from what they were saying, bro, you freaking,
good point.
They
Danny.
Played some clips, you handled it. And, you know, you were very, very patient. You weren't so quick to call him a rat or these other names. And, you know, you bit your tongue knowing probably that, you know, his paperwork was suspect. You know that. I know that. Everybody knows that. And they tried it with you and you wrecked them. So, you know, again, they're being exposed and they're losing.
What's up, Carlos?
Losing big.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right. There's some winners around here, and there's some losers around here.
Yeah. What's up, Frog?
And Gunsmoke's going to survive the ghetto in 2024.
I'm trying.
Not if Loman has his way. He'll be licking shots his way. He's going to go slide.
Come to your house in Queens, man. I said, motherfucker. I hopped on the show real quick after he said that bullshit.
Wait, he really did say that shit?
Yeah, he threatened me on his fucking show. I was like, whoa, 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 whoa. Where the fuck is he getting off with this bullshit? So I went on his show right away. I was like, yo, drop that link. He said, I don't know if I want to drop the link. I was like, no, I got to talk to you, pal. And that started a whole week of depression for him. He fucking, he was about to jump off a ledge. I was getting phone calls. Please back off. Please tell Frank and the guys to back off. I mean, then he showed up on Angel Show crying, you remember?
Yeah, you had psychologists he just got done calling you.
Yeah.
Please.
Angel. And then they put out an APB like, you guys don't know. You're going to push people over the edge. It's like, yeah, what the fuck, man? I mean, he started it.
Yeah. Hey, look. And when it came to those clowns, they pulled up into the genre and they thought they were going to bully certain people and do all this nonsense. And the reality is that we went through way more bullshit from their lies than they've ever had to go through from our truths.
Yeah.
You know, they've lied so much, you know, freaking that memes bullshit. My family was getting harassed. I didn't announce it all on YouTube because I'm not one of those dudes that goes, the second something happens, I go crying on the freaking internet about it. You know, I got to deal with it and, you know, warn my family members that, you know, some clown freaking lied about this thing. And now there's 8 to 10 other guys lying and it's going to create a bunch of bullshit from their psychotic fans.
Yeah.
And it is what it is. You had your family harassed because of these clowns. Anybody that bought into that shit, they're bozos and they know it. And they're just fools and they're trolls, fanboys. You know, they're the kind of kids that were raised in privileged households. So they don't have to do shit in life or work. So they have time to be on the internet all day. There's, you know, it's just a collection of, you know, or retired people that have all this time. It's just a ship of fools. And we went through way more Gunsmoke and Lefty. You took a lot of heat from these clowns dropping videos on you and this other shit.
I didn't take any fucking heat. Oh, I paid no mind. Yo,
yeah, well, that's what I'm saying.
Goofy-ass motherfuckers got something to say. It's still a goofy-ass motherfucker saying it.
You're like a sponge. No. You didn't give a shit. You know, it is what it is, you know?
That bull Italian, my man. Good to see you, bro. I hate these smartphone pocket computers. I'm more old school using flip phones. Damn. That's some old school shit, boy. I used to think I was cool with those fucking flip phones.
Thorn blades, that's some funny shit, dude.
Yeah, fuck that.
He really did the that,
hypocrisy, huh?
Like, of all the people to freaking hit, you don't have to highlight the comment, you know, Gunsmoke, because of whose name is in there. But, you know, that's some funny shit that of all the people to complain about bullying and harassment. Okay.
Yeah, I'm staying away from the bagel shops in Staten Island. It's dangerous territory out there. You ain't never lie, Karma. Thanks for the heads up.
No, but
yo, wait. Whoa.
He was in a fight today? What? BK was in a fight today? Did you hear? No, I didn't hear that.
I didn't hear that.
Please tell us. Enlighten us. What happened?
Yeah. What happened? Let's hear what's up. I want to hear this. BK.
Here he comes. Why don't you guys shut the fuck up? All right, mind your business. What's up, custodian?
Hey, BK punked Argo once on that one show, but then he did show up, and then there was that one, I don't remember that one situation where the cops showed up where they were supposed to meet at a donut shop or whatever the
fuck. Cops hang out, I mean, what the fuck?
But
at least
so BK will
be hanging out. Huh?
If you call BK out, he may fucking pull up and try it, you know, so. You know, he's got more balls than the rest of those guys over there, and he will come on our shows, you know, whereas, you know, like if MRC's talking about me, you, or whatever, and one of us pull up in the chat and say, hey, let me on your panel, he won't let us on because we would wreck his lives. We would destroy that clown in front of his own fans. But BK at least will freaking pull up on the shows and be somewhat entertaining, you know?
Yeah.
He was entertaining yesterday.
Hey, what's up, Thorne?
Definitely. Yeah, I'm trying to get him back here once a week.
Yeah, bro. Once a week, like Tuesdays with BK.
I like Gay Uncle's funny. I would make comment. Oh, yeah.
Did he flipped out a bagel shop?
What's up, huh? Del? Somebody called him a cop, so he got into a fight. Is it safe in here? He isn't here, right? Please let me know. Don't want any trouble.
Yeah, I'm not sure if this is real or not either, Carlos, because I've thrown a bagel shot. It sounds like a joke, possibly, you know, but.
Did you hear? No, I want to hear Templar tell it. Did Templar say that? Because these guys are just joking around about the bagel shit. Gary, thank you for the $3 super sticker and for remembering I have to survive the ghetto here, damn it. Thank you, brother. I appreciate you, Gary. I don't know.
Damn it. Now I want to know this
to be true.
I know. And now I'm interested in finding out. Yeah. You know, we had chemistry. Really?
Yeah, we had chemistry all right yesterday.
Hey, you're good at it, though, because like a lot of dudes, when they have BK on, they don't know how to like keep him in a zone, if you will, where he won't just pop off and then leave the show. You know what I'm saying? You're good, Gunsmoke, at getting him going to where BK does BK's thing, right?
Yeah.
But not so much that he fucking drops out and says, oh, that's it, you know? You kept them there.
No, he was a good sport. He stayed, you know. He didn't run. He stayed, you know. He didn't get too frustrated. I think he lives for it. He likes to... He likes the back and forth and the arguing.
Yeah,
and that's how he has his fun in a sick way.
You did the thing at Henry Hill's bar, you know. Keep him here, Henry. Keep him here.
Yeah.
The Joe Pesci line.
Yeah, you know what? Let's make fun of him so he shows up. Hey, BK, I heard you got beat up today in a bagel shop. Is that true? Come on, man. Say it ain't so. Say it ain't so, BK. Come on, man. Somebody said there's a video being posted around.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You got fucked up? I didn't make it up. Somebody said that right here. Look.
Content. Does anybody have a link to video. It?
Nobody sent me the fucking video.
You got to rinse, drop it. Let's see it.
Mickey says BK's not going to run from anyone. Anywhere.
Nah, he ain't. BK's actually one of the, you know, like I told him
last night. It wasn't bad, man.
BK is the dude that the troll army, if you want to call them that, puts on the front line while the rest of them are MIA or they're in the rear with the gear, you know.
BK Shaolin.
Oh, shit, dude. I'm
summoning God, you.
Carlos, you've summoned him.
I'm going to pull out my Ouija board. BK Shaolin, BK Shaolin, where are you? BK ain't no cop, gotta keep it real. I don't know. That's what I heard, but I guess, you know, I don't think he has the temperament to be a cop. I don't think
they wouldn't let him do that. There's no way he would be allowed.
I knew
to
a sick fuck.
Cop.
He tried to apply for the corrections officer thing, but he failed the mental.
I was just gonna say, yo, there's no way this dude's a cop. Again, there's no way he could pass the psych exam.
He would have been in the news for shooting some fucking guy, like, you know.
Bro,
I thought I saw a gun.
He would
have been
on film beating somebody, you know, with a stick. Yeah. He would have. You know, what do you mean?
You said you weren't speeding.
I saw you speeding.
What's up, Mojo? Good to see you, Mojo baby. Yeah, then he called Apple Italian a druggie yesterday. I mean, what the fuck?
Yeah.
He came up with some bullshit yesterday. But the thing is, he says shit, and then he makes it sound like it's true, you know? That's what I don't like, you know? You're going to slander somebody and then act like it's true. I mean, you don't know this guy, Fat Paul Italian, from a hole in the wall. He's definitely not no druggie, I'll tell you that much.
Well, half these clowns think that I'm him, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, they're idiots, bro.
Yeah, but no, I'll take your word for it, Mustache Pete. You're right. Shouts to Mustache Pete, the real gangsters, y'all. Say what you want about BK, but he's definitely not a punk and will always pull up. Yeah. I want to know if this is true, though. Did he get into a fight already? I mean,
I know. Listen, I do know, and I can confirm he did fight somebody from the YouTube mob.
Do you know who that is?
I do.
Can you tell me personally, privately?
Put it in the chat.
I love people right now. He fought Bay 8th.
Did he? Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that ain't no real fight then.
Oh, it was a real fight.
Yeah. You never know, Gunsmoke, because sometimes these guys get pissed at each other over stuff, and then it.
No, I know, but they were friends. I don't really see them.
Well, no, yeah, trust me, it was a fight, but you know, it was like I don't know. Nobody's ever fucking banged out with a friend before.
I mean, I fought my best friend. It's the only fight I lost. But
yeah, keep in mind, bro, there's been people who you've been friends with or I've been friendly with. We ain't friendly with him anymore, you know. So it's always possible that him and Nine Toe Joe freaking
it's not possible. This is 100%.
Okay, there it is.
Wow.
So
yeah, exactly. But we're still friends to this day.
Nine Toe Joe versus BK.
Bring on Bob Tucker. Yeah, he don't want to come here. Last time, some asshole like, come on, Jeff. It's okay, Jeff. You can come on now. Like we talked about. Come on, Jeff. He's like, no, I don't want to go on there. Nah, you know.
You sound like Mr. Hankey from South Park when you with that come voice.
Come on, Jeff. It's okay, Jeff. <Adio. laughs> Friends always end up fighting at some point. Yeah. No, it happens, especially when you're both the emotionally disturbed individuals, you know? I mean, it could happen, you know? I heard they were living together, too. I don't know, for a while there. So, yeah, I mean...
I didn't hear that, but...
Shit could get real thick real quick.
Oh, yeah.
So I guess BK said he won. He said he won that fight.
He did. He did.
So how tall is this BK guy? I heard the other shit is pretty tall.
I guess it's all a matter of skill.
Well, I guess when you're doped up, anything can happen, right?
Let's be honest, man. That dude fucking looked pretty bad.
Yeah. He wasn't doing so hot. Yeah.
Looked worse than me.
BK flips out when you refuse to present your license and registration. You have to show me! No, sir, I don't have to show you. I have a constitutional right. I don't give a fuck about your constitution. Get the fuck out of the car! Get out of the fucking car! You're under arrest! Yeah, nah, he can't be no cop.
No, he's definitely not. And you know, he gets upset when people even make that
Stop making fun of me about Merlino. You don't know what you're talking about.
You are more likely to fight after some drinks versus weed. Oh, yeah. Alcohol, yeah. Weed don't do that.
Yeah.
He said it yesterday. Yeah, weed is definitely 190. The other asshole was, I heard, 6'2". I don't know.
Like
that's pretty, maybe this guy's fucking, I don't know. This guy's on fucking creatine and steroids or something. I don't know.
But again, you know, it also matters, you know, is someone have experience fighting or are they just going to close their eyes and do the windmill like some people?
Oh, Rocco knew who it was too. But he's loyal to their boys and he wasn't putting it out. No, I respect that too, you know.
Yep.
It's not for anybody to know, but... I mean, I would have rather known privately, but I guess whatever. What are you going to do?
No, I said it fucking, you know, he was on my show yesterday. I was like, yeah, I know who it was, you know. It's not.
Oh, he showed up to your show yesterday?
Oh, yeah, dude. It was actually a pretty good show last night. I had tried to have a, you know, civil and, you know, conversation with dude and put some things in perspective.
Yeah. So.
It all started because I put a fucking picture up of this dude as a cop. And he's like, Lefty, you're a real scumbag, Lefty. And I was like, I'm just joking, but, you know.
You're a scumbag. Yeah.
Sign the waivers, Lefty. Sign the fucking waivers.
Yeah, that was funny yesterday. Yeah. He's like, come on, we'll sign the waiver. We get in the gym.
You don't know about, yo, he was on my chat fucking when we were going at it. And he's like, we need waivers. We need waivers.
Fuck a waiver.
He's got fucking some one-liners that are just fucking, I always leave the ladies disappointed, lefty. I'm like, what?
Oh, gosh, ball bag. Don't you worry about it, Danny Green. My balls are clean. Fresh, fully clean. I heard BK's a sergeant. That's not true. I never got promoted in the force. But be a CI, all confidential informant. I don't know. I don't know. You guys really want him to come in here, huh? You guys are trying to trigger him.
I know, yo, for real.
Honestly, you could find gold in a thrift store sometimes. That's true. I gotta go to those thrift stores, but yeah. What else we got here? If BK died, he'd show up as a poltergeist and terrorize. What do you say? God damn it, Eyelight. You guys think he's a CI, huh?
BK. BK won that shit.
I can't believe it. That's crazy. BK's cool. I don't hate on him. He's funny. He said, you can't shine my balls. Never mind my shoes. I thought, yeah, that is funny. Now you can't say that about shit like that about him or anyone else. That's wrong. No, you're right, Tevin Ace. I'm not saying it. These guys are saying it. I'm not saying it. Thank you, Carlos.
Chris, that's the link to the show he was on.
Let's see. He was taller than Gene from what I remember of that. I guess. Wait, is more by yourself playing Red Dead Redemption? Oh, that Western game bullshit. Where is Rob Gene, damn it? Smoke, so you're saying a fight from YouTube happened and the feds or a lawsuit wasn't involved? That's odd. God damn it, Brian. I gotta start proofreading these fucking these comments. God damn it.
There's wolves and goons around.
Well, I take that, I don't know, that's some sort of justice right there. BK beating up Joe, that's justice.
A little bit of satisfaction.
Yeah, you know, I wish I knew about this a long time ago. I mean, that's fucking awesome. Good for you, BK. I actually like BK now. I think I love BK. I think I might love BK now. I don't know. I'm really going to love Joey Merlino tomorrow when I hear this fucking show. I mean, it's going to be fucking great.
Get some popcorn. Okay.
Get some chicken pot pie.
Yeah, maybe some chicken tenders.
Chris Archilla, thank you. He just subbed to you, lefty.
Thanks, man.
Chris is good peoples. Rocco, no, I don't know for sure, but that's who I was thinking he was talking about when I heard him say a few times that he fought someone on here. I would have never guessed that. Not in a million years would I have thought that. But I guess it makes sense. They did have a falling out for a while, and I didn't know it came to fucking blows, but...
Yeah, apparently BK those guys. Ass.
One thing I do think is people should stop bringing up Rob Gene to him and let Rob address him directly. They live close, and it could start real life shit for the... Yeah, that's why I said earlier at the beginning of the show, like, somebody asked if he heard, and I was like, no, I'm not telling him, and I don't want none of you guys to bring it up to him either. You know, if he finds out on his own, that's his own deal, but because, you know, sometimes you speak foolishly, you don't fucking think about what you're saying or the consequences, and maybe in the moment you might not give a fuck, or you want to portray on here that you don't give a fuck, but when it's time to pay those consequences for your mouth, I mean, you don't want to settle up for that. So, yeah. Right. So I don't want to see nobody get hurt or fucking whatever. So I'm staying out of it. I'm keeping my mouth shut. I don't think Rob knows about it. Rob didn't hit me up. So just leave it alone, guys. You know, Leave it alone. What was said was said, and let's just forget about it. That's what I said earlier. When he was screaming that time outside of the gym on Saturday night, all that was great. Come on! I'm here! I'm waiting! Yeah, that was great. That was classic. Wasn't that on your show, Lefty? Whose show was that on?
Yeah. I think and, that was and, your show, right? We had fucking Nunzio constantly going to the fucking, I forgot the name of the restaurant. And he's like, yo, Lefty, yo, there's an old guy here. You want me to fucking beat him up? I'm like, no! No, dude. He's like pulling guns on random cars and shit. Cause
yeah,
somebody kept, I think it was Handstand, kept fucking with him and telling him, I'm outside this restaurant. He's like, oh, yeah. He did that shit like 10 times.
Yeah. I hate that type of shit. So yo, it's YouTube, bro. Take a fucking chill pill. Put the gun down. Fucking the fuck's wrong with you. BK a serious roid rage? Could be. I don't know. What's up, DP? BK is a funny, misunderstood dude who lets call it what's it is, makes him a well. I don't know what the fuck. I'm confused. Smokey. What up, Scott H? He couldn't run away from BK with six toes. He had the tippy toe, Carmine. He was tippy toeing. Get off of me! No, fuck you! You're gonna get a taste of your own medicine! Get off of me!
You gotta face the fifth of fury.
How's it feel? You made me do this to you. Remember that. Maybe that's how he lost his teeth. I don't know. BK Blue Balls. Blue Balls will do that to you.
He popped up the other day.
If you own a first OG classic Xbox, keep it because you can learn the what? Oh, nice.
Okay.
That's cool. No, I don't have one of those.
I got the fucking, whatever the black box one is.
Yeah.
But I want a fucking Nintendo 64. I still have my GoldenEye game.
I love that fucking theme music on that game. Yeah, that shit was gangster. All right, let me scroll down. Pray for a miracle. I'll kick you all in your asses. Bring anybody you want. Anyone see Loman going off on Merlino the other night? He did? No, I didn't hear that. I stopped watching the guy's show. Let's see.
Maybe we should fucking listen to it.
And I'm your host who's about to get exposed, Jeff Canarsie. I'm on a fake voice. Look at this beauty.
Coming live from the bathroom of a social club.
Let's see what he's saying.
Who he's friends with, you know, and that kind of obviously.
Well, I know he knows me because I know that at least people have told me.
I know he knows
who
me.
Talks to him. And so, like,
it's oh my God.
But what Little Snuff was doing was going by what Joey was saying. Oh, yeah, who's that? Oh, come on. Come on. Yeah, everybody like, sitting in that fucking room that day knew who I was.
Yeah, right.
And one of them sitting in the room doesn't like me. So that don't surprise me.
Yeah.
I wish I was famous. All right, hold on. I did check. I just played it before, Pete. Oh. 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 Hold on. What's this?
Joe, how you feel about Canarsie?
Who?
Jeff Canarsie.
What the fuck's it? he's got my case. It was all right. As far as I know.
Good health to you both.
Who the fuck is
texted,
he?
Call daily, call weekly, sometimes daily. Providing assistance, putting aside my own fucking work to help somebody else, only to watch somebody else get all of the credit for that, never be thanked, and be treated like a jerk off. Is something I'm not going to stand for. And where I come from, there is a thing called respect and loyalty. And, you know, I just feel like I was used and then treated like trash. As if whatever I've done is pointless. It's tossed aside like it don't mean a fucking thing. Oh, he's okay. He was just at my trial. That's like saying we were two ships passing through the waters one night. And it's untrue, and you know it, I know it, and there's dozens of others that know that's bullshit. It's like saying I was some fucking fanboy sitting in a fucking trial, and that's bullshit.
Messages about this idiot that's talking about us. Joe, tell them about what they're saying.
Yeah, we got a ton of messages last night. He did a live video from Carnassi.
Yeah.
Carnassi. I'm going to tell you a story on this Thursday's podcast about him. Yeah, I did know him. He did help me out with 302s. He's a fucking liar. His name ain't even Canarsie. It's Loman, but I'm going to tell you the whole story and why.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, tell us the whole story.
Now. So you can talk all that fucking shit you want, you fucking crackhead.
Yeah, keep talking. We don't care. Haters keep coming.
Keep on hating.
We don't care about anything you're saying. You care about us.
You can't be us. You're dying to be us, you motherfuckers.
You motherfuckers.
Stay tuned. You're going to hear some breaking news
about this. Motherfuckers, you. All right, that's good. That's good. All right, fuck that. Motherfuckers. He constantly spits into the microphone. That's a dental issue. Did he say two ships or two shits? I don't know, Phoenix. Used for what? The ego on these guys. Yeah, I don't know. He said,
yo, him calling people mafia fanboys is,
that's ironic.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's, yeah. People have a tendency to placate people, you know, and I think he's one of them. I think people just like, you ever see people in a conversation, somebody's just saying something and another person be like, I know him, or he's an asshole. He's good. Like people just
bite. Shut up.
Why would anybody from the streets want to be around you because you talk about organized crime? Well, I talk about the history, right? But if South Philly and even New York, especially in Brooklyn, if it's such a fucking enclave, How the hell did I get in then?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. That's enough of that. Were they fighting over NB? That's a good question. I don't know what it was about. I'm just hearing this now where I'm from, where I come from, in Virginia, Rhode Island. He was used and treated like trash. He just wanted to be at my trial. Oh, we lost Jay Shee. I guess we lost him a long time ago. That's exactly what you are, fanboy. Oh, JC's back.
Yeah, where I come from, we have respect. Bro, he's acting like he's going to teach Merlino a lesson here. Shit. Yeah, I don't think he's going to do too well with that. I'm not going to take it. Bullshit. Because,
he said he would take a pinch for Joey.
Yeah, I don't think that. Where I come from, we know about respect, and I'm not taking it. Yeah, Merlino was freaking. Well, he won't do nothing because he's being watched. But if he was not being watched, Canarsie, you ain't gonna do too well against him.
No, not at all.
Bad idea, bro. Bad idea.
Yeah, take your chances, Del. Don't worry about it. It's okay. You could be here. He's not going to beat you up. I wish I had a fucking ego. Jeff needs to go to the doctor and have whatever is stuck in his throat removed. Yeah. It's called cum. If BK flashes his badge, I'll donate. BK, get the fuck in here right now and show us your badge. Let's go. I need all the donations I could get. I got to try to survive the ghetto here. Get in here, BK. I know you're watching out there in the bushes. Fucking open up your wallet, pull out the badge, let's go. Real quick. I don't give a fuck where you get it from. Thank you, Mustache Pete. BK grew up watching Karate Kid and joined the Cobra Kai Dojo School. Yeah, I don't know what it is. These Italians in Brooklyn, they're fascinated by Tai Chi and Kung Fu. They all know this Tai Chi shit. You know, it's like meditation for them. It's pretty funny, actually. You must take off shoes. I'm not taking off my fucking shoes. Now get us a fucking table. You must take off shoes. Merlino's a lion. I guess, that fucking lying shit.
Mr. Moto, I'm not taking off my shoes, and neither is my friend. Yeah. No, give us a table before I smack you.
Oh, wait, he's actually here. Fuck.
Yeah, come on. Yo, another fat, bald Italian. Why don't you show us your heroin needle?
Here we go. Jesus.
Were you not on a live stream saying you were a drug addict, telling your story?
You got the wrong guy. Nah, I never heard that, bro.
It was him.
Nah, that wasn't. I never heard that, bro.
Yes, and he was on video. He was on camera, too. I seen what he looked like and everything.
Nah, what does he
look like? He's an older guy.
How much older?
Maybe like 50s?
Not really. I mean,
late 40s, 50s?
He's in his 40s. Does he have hair?
Gray hair. I think it was gray from what I remember.
Wrong guy.
Nah, listen, it was a while
ago. This guy's old.
It was him, bro. The name was another fat, bald Italian.
Nah, see,
he's finally saying he's finally on camera. He's finally on the show. What are you talking
about? I think I know what you're talking about. It wasn't him. It was somebody else. But yeah.
Well, how about you come on now? You got a lot to say. Why don't you come on now? You don't got to show your face. Talk.
Joe Bananas, what's up?
He won't, though. He'll just type.
He's just breaking your balls. He just wants you to come on the show, bro.
I know you, though.
We love you here. Come on.
Yeah, we do. BK, can you confirm? You don't have to say who, but was there a confrontation that you won this morning?
There was no fight today.
Somebody said you got
to. I saw that earlier. You were saying that. I was laughing. I was driving. I'm laughing. Yeah. What fight today?
Okay. All right. Yeah. You heard it from the horse's mouth. No confrontation.
Yeah, rumors get spread like that. You see?
Yep. Yeah, rumors get spread.
But I'm laughing. These are all fucking concerned and fucking wanting to know what happened. I'm driving.
Yeah, we want to know what happened.
The fuck?
Yeah, so look,
Carl. But you're still with, like, balls. Huh? You too, though. You're still saying nonsense. It's not breaking balls. You're talking nonsense, bro.
I just wanted you to come back on the show. That's all. I got what I wanted.
Would you like if I started rumors about you, though?
You kind of did already.
No, I didn't. What was the rumor?
I don't even want to repeat it because it makes me aggravated with you. I'm starting to like you now.
Right. You didn't come outside. That's the truth.
No, not that. Something else.
What? No, I want to know now because I don't even know what you're talking about.
No,
you have to say it now.
That's going to piss me off if you say the wrong thing.
You're already thinking about it, so it don't make sense.
Yeah, I'm just going to let it go.
Nah, just go ahead. I want to hear it now. Come on, be a man.
Be a man.
I'm not going to get crazy.
No. You said something about me being a parent. That's complete bullshit. You know,
I didn't say. Are you kidding me? I was in the chat that day. I said nothing. Bro, I'm not the one that made the comment that even started that fucking conversation.
Oh, I thought it was you. Okay.
I was in the chat, yes. But I didn't say nothing about that. Angel's the one that said you're a good father and everything.
Yeah.
She responded to somebody else's comment. I'm not the one that made the comment. You.
Oh, okay. So I got it.
I never did anything like that on here. So stop saying that.
All right. No, that's fair.
And then
solved an issue there.
See, you got that resolved.
That's why you got to fucking say what you're talking about. Just like that other accusation fucking, you made. You got to like that really turns my head. That shit too. I'm not gonna forget about it.
All right. And then I heard another thing today about another fight
what's that?
You had. So I want to congratulate you. I want to thank you actually for that,
bro. Get out of here! I don't even know what you're talking about. I have no clue what you're talking about. No idea. Okay.
All right. That's fair.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
You're not going to beat up Dell for being here, right? He's afraid you're going to beat him up just for being
here. He's another one. Stop acting like a fool. With that fucking nonsense. Get over it already.
Marky Mark, thank you for the support, brother.
All right.
It fixes the lies. Yeah,
did you say that Staten Island is not a part of New York? One of the five boroughs. What are you talking about? Long Island's not one of the five boroughs. Staten Island is...
No, I know, but you understand that it's called the Forgotten Borough.
No, it's called Baby Brooklyn. What are you talking about?
Baby Brooklyn? I never heard that.
Well, I know that's where you don't get out much. You don't hear a lot of things, bro. Seriously.
You
didn't even know who Miguel Cotto was one time. I heard somebody ask you. Yeah, he's a boxer. You don't know who Miguel Cotto is.
I've heard of Cotto. I didn't know his first
name. He's a fucking famous boxer. He fought Mayweather and shit. That's all your era. You should know this stuff.
Yeah. No, you're right. I should know that because I wasn't the boxing back then.
So you're naive to some shit. That's my point.
Yeah. But look, I don't know.
Trust me, I've been around the block way more than you, bro, and I'm not just saying that.
No, I doubt that. But
no, I know that for a fact, bro. And it's not
probably you kept up with it, but
this is,
you know,
it's not a dick measuring contest right now. No, I've been around the block more than you. Trust me.
I doubt it.
I know for a fact that has. That's it. No. End of the story. Let's leave it at that.
No, I was completely different years ago, but we'll leave it at that.
Yo, BK, you should declare your independence from all these different groups. Like you, you know, because with the troll people, you're like the only one with the cojones to pull up on, you know, these shows and all that.
JC, you keep saying, I keep hearing you say that. You make no sense, though. Nobody's telling me to pull, to jump on shows or anything. I do what I want to do. No, I know
you ain't being ordered around, bro. What I'm saying is, like,
and, you know, and I like the people that you consider the troll army. I like them. I'm cool with them.
Well, so. Not all. All right. I mean, I understand all that part of it.
If they bother you, what does that got to do with me? You understand?
Well, no, I just like I told Gunsmoke yesterday. I'm just yesterday. Saying, though, that you are like the dude that always has to put in the work. You know, you
no,
do
but I don't have to do anything. I'm just do it when I feel ordered, it's time.
But you do put in the work, and they don't.
And you know, people make it like just because I don't have a channel, like oh, I don't. You know what I'm saying? My voice don't mean anything here. I've been around since the beginning, number one. I did have a channel with somebody. I had my own channel, okay?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm part of the best moments on this motherfucker. You try to make it like I'm obsolete on here?
Not at all. I'm saying you're like, you're so independent-minded that you can be your own entity.
I just don't want the stress that comes along with a channel and all that shit. Yeah. It ain't worth it to me. I'd rather work a channel, and do what I gotta
do. Be an independent person to where you, you know, you're pretty much like, you already are.
But I am independent
in your own way.
I am independent. Like, I just stick up for my friends.
Don't let any of those clowns over there though, like get mad at you when you do something.
But they're not.
Sometimes they try to talk shit to you.
No, they haven't did that in a long time. Now they know who I am as a person after seeing me 3 years on here. Back then, they you know they were figuring me out still. I guess you know.
Okay.
After seeing consistency for years, they know what's up. I've fought battles for everybody on here. They know,
bro. So I'm gonna give you that, you know, and you know, you're liked on many levels across the board. Then you're obviously hated by some.
JC, I don't even think I'm hated. How do you like that? And if I'm hated,
even your haters love you in their own way.
They do. I know they do, bro. So you want to know how I know? I'm confident in who I am.
Well, I know the reaction I get. Always go up when you.
I know how people in real life feel about me. Everybody loves me.
Yeah, the numbers go up when you're on a show, you know.
You think people hate me and shit. And Gunsmoke.
Yo.
I am a nice guy. I'm a very nice guy. You fuck with me, though, I could be a motherfucker.
I mean, that's what a lot of people.
And I'm quick to fucking flip. Like the switch, you know what I'm saying? I could turn it up in an instant. In a fucking instant.
Yeah, you got to work on that.
Maybe I do. But you know what? No. I don't know. I take pride in it. Because not everybody can be like that.
I got to bounce. I got to go pick up my kid. And besides that, I think Anthony wants to hop on. So he'll be the new, be the replacement. So you guys enjoy. Thanks, Lefty. Thanks, Gunsmoke. BK, good to see you. And keep us entertained by being you. That's all you got to do, bro. You are entertaining.
Just keep being you.
And we like him. Well, you know, I like him. I think he's an entertaining dude in his own way. So enjoy.
All right, man. Take care.
Thank you, JC. Here's Tevin Ace, my man. What's up?
What's up? BK.
What's up?
We're good and we're bad. We got problems being you. I didn't think we did.
I mean, you take shots here and there.
Honestly, bro.
You know you do. I catch you taking little shots.
Hold on. Look in the chat. Look back in the chat. Someone said a few things. I said, you can't say that. And I think if you ask Smoke, I mean, if you want a problem, we can have one. But I never had a problem.
Anthony, you don't want a problem.
Nah, bro. Well, neither do you, BK. No, I never had a problem.
I embrace it.
Nah, you don't embrace it.
Come on, stop it.
Stop the tough talk.
Anthony, you're the one that said I don't want a problem. And I'm telling you, I do want a problem.
Don't talk tough. Who's talking tough?
You know where to find me. You know where. Get in touch with your friend, and I'll meet with you. BK, you can back your mouth up. I'll give you a chance.
First of all, I'm going to tell you straight out. I ain't fighting you, bro. That ain't never going to happen.
You could do what you got to do. It's not about do what you got to do. Listen, your boy could fucking bring it to the pizzeria, and you do what you got to do when you get there.
He first of all, Rob Jean's not my boy. I would come down by myself, but I'm not fighting you, BK.
And you would fucking leave fucking crying.
What's that?
You would leave crying.
You know what? You're not going to even bait me to say anything. That's whatever.
Who's baiting you? Who's baiting you? Don't say anything.
No, it's fine.
Show up.
Look back in the chat. Look back in the chat and see what I said about you just before. Someone said, oh, maybe he's a CI. You know what I said? You can't say that about him. But you don't see that.
But people on here know people I know. You make no sense when you're saying stupid shit like that.
Yeah, well, listen. You know what? Whatever, but listen.
You make no fucking sense. You make, here, you want to listen to something?
Yeah, let's see.
Yeah, whatever.
Let's see. Listen, I had to find this yesterday from your boy Drum Capella's own fucking mouth.
You had a what?
I had to record this yesterday.
Oh, you said you're a good guy.
This is fucking idiot. Hold on.
Thank you, Sean.
Some of the best pool players, like, ever. So you guys remember those Yacht Rock back in the day? I didn't, but BK did. You know, BK actually knows my nephew. My nephews know him. And a couple of guys that were pretty heavy in the neighborhood that we have that are mutual friends. But I was cool. Yacht Rock was my name because I had one of the most successful yachts.
What's that? Yeah. I don't know what that is.
You're a fucking jerk off.
What's that?
You're a jerk off.
Okay, BK, whatever you say, bro. Go.
You're a fucking loudmouth. That's what you are.
I'm not a loudmouth. Go listen to somebody else. Go ahead.
You're a fucking loudmouth. Look at you. I can tell you're a bitch by looking at your picture.
Oh, come on.
Hey, you're a fucking 63-year-old fucking jerk off.
Seatbelt by the feet for.
But nobody's even lisping. You sound stupid right now.
You know what you are?
Nobody's even lisping. You're not funny.
You're a faggot.
I'm what?
Anybody on here knows.
Look at you. You're shiny, bro. You're shiny, your face. Why are you shiny? It looks like somebody polished your fucking face with their fucking balls.
BK, suck a cock. You're a faggot.
Who rubbed their cock all over your face and polished your face?
You're a faggot.
You shiny fucking red jerk off.
Yeah, that's right. I'm shiny. That's right.
Yeah, your head looks like top tomato with that red ass face.
Go take your fucking Prozac or whatever it is.
Prozac? What the fuck are you talking about, you little fucking midget Danny DeVito looking motherfucker?
Listen to how I'm talking to you. You faggot cocksucker.
But you won't say it to my face. You won't say it to my face.
You come over here. I don't give a fuck.
You won't. I'll come there right now.
Come, you fucking faggot.
You little fucking bitch.
Suck a cock, you fucking pussy.
You little fat fuck.
Whatever, dude.
Look at you. Smoke. You look like fucking...
Smoke.
You look like Vin Diesel in that fucking movie where he played the fucking mobster lawyer.
Whatever, dude.
You fucking jerk off. Look at you.
Yeah.
Oh, well,
show with rats.
You got a cocksucker face.
Howie would have stomped you back in the day. Frank will still stomp you. And you know what?
It's easy to say all that, all right? You fucking rat-loving jerk off.
You're a faggot is what you are.
You get no respect. You're a rat lover.
Go suck. Yeah, whatever, rat lover.
You're a rat lover.
Yeah, call Howie a rat to his face.
You're a rat. Yeah. He'll do nothing.
Oh, yeah, right.
He'll attempt. Listen. Hold up.
You want to talk about attempt?
Listen. He'll attempt to do something. He can do what he got to do. I'm not saying, you know what? These guys, just because they did what they did doesn't mean they didn't do things before that.
Everybody knows. You're all talk. That's the word. Everybody talks about that. The word is
Anthony.
Out.
What are you talking? Didn't you just hear them saying they fought somebody already?
Yeah,
who's all
you fight that kid? Come on.
But what did you do? What did anybody else do?
Listen, I don't have
you
to.
Listen,
fight
what?
Anymore.
You flapping fucking jerk off?
BK, I don't come on here causing trouble with nobody. I'm almost 60 years old. If you want to
so talk, shut your fucking mouth, you raisinette looking motherfucker.
Whatever, dude. You're funny. You're hysterical.
I'm not trying to be hysterical. I'm looking at you.
But you are, BK.
You're purple in your picture.
Come on, man.
You know who told me to come on here?
Did you check your fucking...
Come on here. Hey, you know what Howie told me to
do? Did you check your fucking blood pressure today?
He told me to come laugh at you, and that's just what I'm doing.
You're not laughing though. You're shitting your fucking depends right now. You're shitting your depends in reality.
You fucking go home.
But then why don't you? But why don't you step then? But why don't you step? But why don't you step?
I'm laughing, bro. Whatever, dude.
We can make it happen, right?
Bro, I'm 60 years old. You want to make it happen? Whatever. God bless.
But you like to say whatever, whatever. You're 60. But don't talk. Don't talk like a tough guy then.
You grew up in a place where there was somebodies and you're a nobody.
How the fuck do you know, though? How do you know? How the fuck do you know, Anthony Jerkoff?
You know what, dude? You might want to ask around because I you know, I do know people, Daddy. They tell me you're a wish you were.
You don't know, bro. Come down and come to the fucking place. Come to the fucking place on Staten Island.
It's that important to me, BK.
But don't say it then, because I'll prove you wrong.
Say about you.
I'll prove you wrong.
You walk around with chest out, people laugh at you. That's all. I'm not.
No, they don't laugh. You can laugh behind the scenes, but you won't do it to my face.
I don't care.
As usual.
But you so what? They're still laughing at you.
Because I had them all in my face and they do nothing.
Calm it down,
bro.
They
kiss fucking asshole.
I don't know, bro. Listen.
I know. I was there.
Fuck the world for, man. No,
I was there, motherfucker.
Whatever, BK. Listen.
Yeah, whatever what, big mouth?
And have a little fun.
You're a little man with a big fucking mouth. That's what you are.
BK, I don't have a big mouth because I'm still in no trouble, honestly.
You no, came on his really thought in trouble, you little
the
fucking
guy's
red
a complete
meatball.
Gentleman. Kevin Ace is a gentleman. He actually stood up for
wait,
you today.
I want to get out of here.
You little red fucking meatball.
Oh, wait, God. I'm going to write that down. How do you spell? Oh, wait, you don't know how to spell red, do you? How do you spell? Oh, you don't know how to spell
it. You're not funny. These are like third grade jokes right now. At a nervousness. You're so nervous. You're making third grade jokes.
I'm nervous.
And you're laughing at a nervousness.
Yeah, no, BK.
I'm very composed. Can't you tell?
No, I'm laughing at you, BK, because you're a sorry person.
But you're not laughing. You're not laughing.
I do. I feel bad.
You're not laughing. After this, you're going to be laughing at yourself and crying because you're going to know you look like a jerk off on here.
Oh, my God. You're hysterical, bro.
I'm hysterical. I'm not trying to be. I'm glad you find me funny.
You know, and here, I'm an idiot because I said that there's no way he got smacked around a bagel shop today. I defended you, but you know what?
I don't care if you fucking defended me. You're telling the truth. You did. You're just telling the fucking truth. How about you come and try it?
Well, I don't need to. I don't need to, BK. It doesn't mean anything to me besides
the fucking store will be redesigned that fucking day.
I don't get anything out of it. I don't get anything out of it.
Every
but you came on here talking shit, though. You came on here talking shit.
I came on asking if we were okay.
With your fucking suit looking like a fucking 2 foot tall jerk off with a big mouth.
I'm not 2 foot tall. I'm probably close to your height, but who cares?
No, you're not.
I'm 6 foot. So what are you, 6'1"? Big deal.
What the fuck, yo?
And what does that matter? You look like you're 2 foot tall.
Well, so what? How? Because you can see my head? How would you even get that?
You got a midget head. I don't know.
Midget head. Honestly,
you look like a half a midget.
Yes. I got a giant head. My head is huge, unfortunately.
Well, midgets usually have big heads, no? They have little bodies and big heads.
Listen, Smoke saw me. If a midget is just about 6 foot, then I'm a midget.
No fucking midget. Nah, he ain't.
You need a big head to carry that big fucking mouth.
I don't have a big mouth. That's the thing I don't understand.
Yo, custodian, if I was dressed right now, I'm not even dressed because I just got home from fucking work and stuff.
Right.
Okay. I would fucking go on camera right this second. Nobody looks like Seth Green, so it's another thing.
Bro, God bless you. I'm glad you. I don't wish you no bad, though.
I get more fucking girls than all he is on here put together.
Bro, you know what? You don't want to go. You don't want to bark up that tree. I'm 60 years old. I did mighty well.
Bro, I don't give a fuck what you did. It's all about now.
Here's the thing, BK. I hope you are. I am not wishing you nothing bad. That's the thing you're missing. I'm not missing you. I'm not wishing you nothing bad. I'm not. So, you know, whatever.
Why you come up here running your fucking mouth then?
But BK, what was the first thing I said to me? Are we good?
And I told you I seen you talking shit in the past. And
but
that's
tell
the
me
truth.
Where.
I'm not going to say. I don't take screenshots of it.
Where?
I seen it. That's it.
Nah,
just
I
like
know.
I seen that fucking another fat old Italian dick face on a fucking show. And they're
you
all
denying. Leave him out of it, bro. He ain't doing nothing to you.
Okay, he's an ex-junkie, and that's it.
Hey, BK, he didn't
kill him.
That's why he keeps saying what he's saying about me. He's so offended by it.
I met this guy. He keeps going fucking away.
BK, let me say one thing. If you, honest to God, if you could show me where I said bad about you, I'll admit it. I think I've
been. You didn't call Staten Island a fucking dump one day? You didn't call Staten, did you call Staten Island a dump one day when people were talking about me?
No. The Staten Island dump.
No, you said Staten Island's a dump. You said it's nothing but a dump.
They called Angel the Staten Island dump. Do you remember that from the TV show? They called Angelina.
But that's not even
I
how
like
you
Staten Island.
Yeah, but that's not.
I got
that's
Albanian
not how you
friends
refer
there. I love Staten Island. I wish I could afford to live on Staten Island right now. I'm not calling Staten Island a dump. No, next one. Go ahead.
But you did though that day. Now you're twisting it right now.
No, I'm not. I'm telling you, I love Staten Island. Well, listen.
All right, but that day when you didn't get called out on it, when nobody was fucking was saying nothing about it, you were fucking talking against it, and I take offense to that. I live here.
If I said
Staten and that was the topic, right? When they were talking, that's how you brought up Staten Island because they were saying the guy from Staten Island, the big mouth from Staten Island. Okay, and you said Staten, and you were like,
show me,
and you were like, Staten Island's nothing but a dump. You were on the panel.
Nah, Staten
acting
Island,
fucking cocky.
Well, hold on a minute. Well, nothing for nothing. I worked on that dump for years, so it was a dump for a
another fat bald Italian. You talk tough with these stupid lines from the fucking 80s. Tevin East will eat your lunch. Come up on the fucking panel, dick.
Listen,
you can't even do that.
Listen.
You mutt.
Jeez.
Eat your lunch. What is this?
Listen.
1979? You fucking jerk off?
Hey, listen, just because we're older and you don't make fun, bro. You're going to be old someday.
I know. But you know what? I'll age gracefully because I take
care
of myself.
And so did I, bro. And so did I. Trust me, I did. Okay? And I hope you age. Listen, I hope you age gracefully. You retire. You got a big pension. You got a beautiful children. And I wish all of that for you. Okay? And
I'm bad on you either. All I said was if you have something to say, you just say it to me.
All right.
And that was it.
Okay. So we're at
say it in person and that's it.
Okay.
That doesn't mean I wish you bad.
Listen to me. I ain't wishing you no bad, okay? I'm not. I'm not going to fight you because I'm too old to fight. All right, I am. I'm 60 years old. I'll defend my family if I have to. All right. Other than that, I'm not looking to fight no more. I haven't fought in 20 years. Okay. And I won a lot.
Who needs it at this fucking age? Over what? YouTube shit? Come on.
All right. And we're on YouTube, bro. Yeah. Are we
gonna Every insult does not require a response or to be handled with
fists. I just feel like, I don't know. If you talk in a certain way.
No, I mean, if you're in your 20s, somebody talks shit, you handle your business. But 40, 50, 60 years old, you can't be doing this, bro.
You don't want to fight everybody. You're gonna have the mindset like I do sometimes.
I'll tell you this. I'm never going to lose a battle. I'll make sure of that.
Everybody loses. Come on. Everybody loses some. If you ain't lost a few, you haven't been in the street long enough. Come on.
I've been jumped. I've been jumped by fucking 30 people at a time. I've been in battles like that.
You have, but I'm just saying to you. Everybody in the street, eventually, there's always somebody stronger or better than you. It just comes to that. And I can't listen. But the thing about it is,
I'm not saying, you know, I'm not even out here. What do I do other than back myself up?
No, but you go too far.
You make like I'm on here playing Superman. I'll back myself up.
I mean, yesterday you said you want to meet up with 10 guys.
I ain't saying that. I'm just telling you, I got no issues with you. I was actually a little surprised when people said that, oh yeah, BK was bad. But I said, all right, whatever, no big deal. Then you were honest, you know, let me just come on and talk to him. You know, listen.
Well, Gunsmoke is making it like people are stirring up shit behind the scenes and everything.
He made me lash out
on a couple of people.
BK, you don't think that don't happen? Come on. They love to
He thinks I'm making it up.
You get going.
You are.
You bring people to the show.
I wouldn't make something like that.
You know. So then bring the guy on here. Why can't he come on and have a conversation?
Who, me?
No, I'm talking now Gunsmoke.
Maybe he doesn't want to fucking talk about it. I don't know.
That doesn't make sense, though. You have somebody lying to you. Read between the lines.
Be careful with this kid because he might be a cop. I'm hearing.
Okay, what about the other 90,000 people? You're listening to this one asshole that we don't even know who the fuck he is.
Look, I don't believe it.
There's a bunch of other people on here that all know each other, know me, know people I know, everything.
You don't have the temperament to be a cop. You don't have the temperament to be a cop, and I don't think you could act this
good. I mean, it's ridiculous. If it wasn't for the stupidity, I wouldn't even be on here.
Nobody's gonna
fucking do that on here. Because I don't do that to fucking people. I don't fucking slander people. I'm very up fucking front.
Yeah.
I'll make fun of your face, your hat, your fucking clothes, whatever. You're broke, you this, you that. I don't fucking talk about families. I don't do no slander and shit. I don't do that. All right?
BK.
What's up?
You're ugly.
Oh, come on, man.
All right. I'm playing with you.
I know.
We're good. I came on here like a man to talk to you. All right? Listen, you got a little hot. You said some things. I came back. I said some things.
Listen, you're going to defend yourself. You're a man, right?
I'm a man. I expect it. And like I said, I won some, I lose some. But you know the thing about it is, I will stand in. I don't win them all, but I'll stand in. You know what I mean? And I'll get respect on that. But at 60 years old, BK.
Listen, not everybody even jumps on a panel with me. So you know what? You get a little respect for that. Right?
Listen, I got respect for you. I do. And I'm telling you, if you can find a thing of me saying that you're an idiot or this, that, or the other, I'll admit it. I think you got to go pretty hard. And I don't know that could be found.
I just saw a couple of little subtle things. Let's put it that way. Maybe not direct, but like subtle little slights.
Backdoor things like some other people from other shows like
the game. It could have been worse. Let's put it that way.
All right.
I could deal with that bullshit.
All right. How about this? We're good.
Listen, shit happens, bro. You had your first argument with me. There you go.
All right. Wait, do we give Smoke some entertainment in the crowd here?
This was great. I thank the both of you.
And honest to God, I'm going to tell you straight out. When I came on here and I said to you, are we good? I thought you were going to say, we're okay. I really didn't.
We had to get that out of the way, and we did. So.
We got off on like I should say, we got off on the wrong foot.
Yep.
Oh, this guy.
All right, listen.
How could you hate this kid, huh? How could you hate
him? I'm trying to tell him. I really don't. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, so. you try to paint me as a fucking animal. He's not mentally ill. He's disturbed. He's stalking people. This is what you say about people. All this crazy
BK, you know
shit.
What he said one time about me? I came on panic. He goes, oh, here comes trouble. No. I'm not trouble.
Roro, things.
Get around and laugh.
I'm like that, too. I feel like if you could dish it, you should take it. You should be able to take it if you could dish it.
Yeah.
Roro, that haircut, please. Change the fucking Aquanet Buffon.
BK, do you mind me asking how old are you? Oh, just both.
I'm close to 40. Close. Right. A few years away.
I'm close to 60. So you're the 20 year lesser version of how I kind of am. When I was your age, I was still that way. You'll see. As you get up a little bit more, you know, you don't, just don't have it anymore. You know what I mean? But you don't ever lose it because it don't go away.
You're born. Yeah, you are who you are at the end of the day. You know?
You know what I mean? But
maybe your body, I guess, eventually just slows down. Dude, you know?
You get,
listen, man, you're not part of this genre until you fight with BK at least once.
I guess.
Hey, Lefty, who the fuck asked you? Come on, BK.
I didn't even know you're still here, Lefty.
Lefty, I'm joking. Lefty, how you doing?
Yeah.
All good?
Yeah, I suppose.
I'm playing with your brother. Who else on the panel? Just BK, me, and Lefty?
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, everybody.
All right, man. I'm glad we were able to, get that resolved or whatever.
And yeah, and if anything pops up, please screenshot it or something. All right, let me see, because I don't think there's people.
Bro, it's really not that. If it was that serious, I would have been on the show. Like, yo, where's Anthony? Where's Anthony? It just happened. We happened to cross paths today, you know. So I had to bring it up.
You know what it is? I kind of like, this is all right. This is all right. I like this. I'm gonna go on with PK. I was kind of, you know. Listen, I didn't want to come on and have, you know, I thought when I said that, it might have went the other way. But when you came out of your heart, I was like, okay, here we go. This is okay.
No, you went back. There you go.
We'll have a little fun with this, right?
That's it.
And if I come to Staten Island, you're buying pizza.
I got you. We'll go with Rob.
Yeah, leave her alone, too. She's okay.
Just no donuts.
No. Who, Roro, are you talking about?
No. Yeah, no, I'm not going with Rob. Not you. That's not directed to
him. Oh, nice. So we'll go with Rob to the pizza.
Oh,
place.
Yeah, Rob Jean. Yeah. Perfect. All right, guys, listen. BK. Be good, buddy.
No doubt, bro. Pleasure. Take care. Have a good one.
Nice. Love you, brother.
Later.
I'm bouncing off, guys.
All right, bro.
All right, have a good one, bro.
Goodbye. Enjoy. Goodbye. BK. Peace. Goodbye.
All right, so that was settled. That's good.
All right, guys, I'm going to jump off. We had some shit resolved.
Yeah.
I'm out too.
We cleared some things up today. That's good. So you didn't get into a fight today?
No, there was no fight today.
All right.
People come in all like they know what the fuck they're talking about, too. It's hysterical. All right, man.
Stay out of trouble, all right, guys?
No doubt.
Right,
no doubt.
Take care.
All right, take fellas. Care. Later, guys.
Later.
He does seem like an okay guy, right, Chris? Yeah. I mean, I can't hate the guy, you know. It's hard for me, you know. He's a character. He's definitely a character. Not even 40 years old yet. Yeah. No, we're still young. Thank you, Jay Shee. All right, guys. Well, wait until your joints start hurting, you'll calm down. Yeah. Look, age catches up to all of us. You know, we're not getting any younger. And time flies, you know. These years are going by real quick. So, I mean, my life is already halfway over. So, it's crazy. CBK has a lot of love to give when you talk to him right. I guess, yeah. He's just very emotional, but I guess that's a part of being Italian, you know. Our blood runs hot because our hearts are big. It's not about not having it. It's about growing up in maturity. That's right, Joe Bananas. I mean, I used to be an asshole too many years ago, believe it or not. Don't let this face fool you. I used to be a real asshole. I used to hang out with a bunch of fucking assholes. And my grandmother used to call me, "You hang out with that rough crowd." But, you know, I saw all my friends go to jail. And I escaped it by the skin of my balls, you know. There were plenty of times I could have fucking went away, you know. But I don't know. I had an angel on my side looking over me. And once I saw all my friends, you know, get into crazy shit, serious shit, I said, you know what, this isn't for me anymore. I'm done. I don't want to hang around these assholes. I don't need the stress. Every time a cop pulls up next to you, you start fucking getting paranoid. You know, I don't need that shit. I walked away a long time ago, especially when my son was born. That was it. That was it for me. You get a square job, and, you know, who the fuck needs a criminal record, you know? Plus, I didn't want to fucking break my grandmother's heart. And, you know, and I'm glad with my decision, you know? I don't need friends like that. Running from cops, stealing drugs, hurting people, killing people, robbing people. I don't need that shit. And over the years, I changed, you know. I calmed down, and I just don't even want to deal with the bullshit, you know? It's not that I haven't been around the block. Trust me, I've been all over fucking New York doing crazy shit in my youth. It's nothing to brag about. I don't brag about it. I don't talk about it. I don't talk about it because I don't want to seem like I'm bragging about it. And half of you wouldn't believe this the shit I would say anyway, so why even tell it, you know? Loman's going to start selling T-shirts. He better figure out something because you can't tell mob stories anymore. I mean, especially after tomorrow. We'll see. I mean, look, I'm not saying it's going to be the end-all, be-all for him, but it's definitely going to be a horrible, how you call it? It's going to be a bad situation for him. I don't know how he could do damage control. He's just going to send out a whole bunch of cease and desist letters to Joey's lawyer. I mean, I already know his protocol, you know. First, he's going to try to reach out to the, you know, mutual friends. And then he's going to start with the lawyers to get the video taken down tomorrow. And then he's going to threaten suicide or say that he's receiving threats. I already know his playbook. I've seen it a few times on here already, so... Phoenix, baby, ever have a load of laundry where the agitator is out of whack? No, but I do have to do laundry today. You have to throw your weight on it and hold on for dear life until it stops. Damn. That sounds like a problem, girl. Maybe the book nerds or gamers would have been better friends. Once they move to hard drugs, it makes people crazy. You can always tell when someone lies on here versus the truth. That's right, Mickey. For the most part, Danny Trio had me fooled. Danny Trio was a good liar. I took him at face value. Is his whole show based on knowing Merlino? No, not just Joey, but he basically hinted that he was connected, you know. He's a connected guy. He knows, he knows some guys. No, we're not talking politics, Farmer. You really want to get these people riled up. Green lit. Loman made a fantasy world where he was friends with these guys, and now Joey himself is calling them out in front of the world. This has to be the most This has to be the most humiliating thing anyone has experienced. Yeah, it's going to be bad. He did it to himself, though. He shouldn't be on here lying, you know, making up stories, acting like, you know, I know Joey Merlino, so that makes me better than you. I got more credibility than you. Carmine, Gunsmoke, maybe one day I'll talk about my experience. You know, my friends, the two brothers from Staten Island, got locked up with 9 other guys. Yeah, no, I know you got a story to tell, Carmine. And I'd love to have you on the show one day. You could definitely come on here and tell your story. That'd be awesome. He's an associate of an associate of an associate. Yeah, that's how I took it. I don't know. He's got connections in Philly. I mean, he made it sound like he was hanging out with fucking Phil Narducci and all these other people. And I don't like to drop names, but I never said that. I never said that. Trio was too quick to say he had pics of Wild Bill with a mustache. You still have an angel on your side. She said you're a sweetheart. No, she said that a long time ago. But she did stick up for me the other night, and I really do appreciate that. That was nice of her. She didn't have to go out of her way to say that. But I appreciate that. Thank you, Angel. Uh-oh, here we go. Beep, boop, beep, beep, beep. Oh, my God, they're talking about you. He just said your name. He might have been saying nice things, but it sounded horrible. These are not men. He's talking about you. What'd he say? Oh, you don't want to know. Meanwhile, all I did was just say thank you so much for the nice things you said about me the other day. No, that's not what you said. He said horrible things about you. I just broke my ninth vase against the wall this month. On your next show, you should have Frank on and review clips from his trip to Rhode Island. You want to take a trip down memory lane? Yeah, we could do that. We could take a trip down memory lane. Those animals on that channel, that gun poke, he's not a man. These aren't men. What are we playing Jeopardy now? What is Bayeth? I'm not even going to answer that question. There's a lot I could say there. What about a story without being connected to the mob or being locked up? What kind of story do you want to hear? You don't want to hear oh, look, we got a troll here. I wonder who that could be. Could that be Fish? Gotta be Fish, right? He's not that creative. Yeah, baby. Baba Booey boy. All right, let me scroll up here, boy. That's a good idea, Mickey. I don't know. I mean, we are in the mob genre, I guess. I don't know. Maybe not, but you don't want to hear a crime story. What kind of story could we talk about? I want to hear about a story of redemption. Nah, fuck that. I want to hear a story about success and overcoming obstacles. But those stories are boring, you know. Nobody wants to hear a feel-good story. There's no suspense in there, you know. People want to hear the fucking trials and tribulations of a shithead, you know. I don't know. No, he didn't fight nobody. Oh, yeah, well, he did, but not today. I don't want to repeat it, but that's why I never borrowed money. Remember when Danny Trio's ex said he couldn't get erection? No, I don't remember that, Greenlit. What mafia? He slept at the Knights of Columbus. Was it the Knights of Columbus? I think so. Something like that. He's got my name tattooed on his ass. He left me. Last thing, you guys were funny yesterday with the word herb. We used that word in Buffalo in the mid-90s, too. Yeah, it's an old 90s term. You're a herb. We call people herbs. Yeah, we all did that. No, it's not a Buffalo thing. We were saying that over here in school. When in doubt, whip it out. I mean, look it up. Damn. All right, let me scroll up here, boy. I don't know what you're talking about, boy, but all right. That's right. Just tell the cop you know BK. He'll let you off. Yeah, I don't need a PBA card. I'll just say I know BK. See, you're talking shit again. All right, relax. It's a joke. Take it easy. Root Irish, my dude. God damn it, Root. What the hell's going on here today? I see you guys fighting in the chat today. I don't know what the hell's going on with that. At least three or four of you were fighting today in the chat. You guys got to take it easy, huh? We're here to hang out and have a good time. I mean, everybody was using the word herb back then. I don't know. It's universal. Yeah, that's right, Rocco. It's universal. I mean, they're probably using that shit on the West Coast too. Who knows? I live north of Buffalo, north of the border. I never heard that term. We had other lingo like Cheegs. What the fuck? Cheegs or Stogues or a smoke? Yeah. Well, we used to call them bogeys. A Stogue is like a cigar. But the Korean kids used to walk up to us in high school like, yo, you got a Stogue, yo? You got a Stogue? And we're like, yo, it's a bogey, bro. It's a bogey. Oh, look, another troll. Who gives a fuck? Yeah, meet up with him. Why the fuck would I meet up with him? He's nobody special. A fucking clown. What are you, his dick sucker? What do you, lick his ass? Fuck him and the horse he rode in on. Where's he going to get the money from to come here? Don't even get me started, please, because I know you're just here to instigate shit, you fucking weirdo. Throw this guy out of here, fucking moron. There was some sort of shooting in Philly. Hey, there he is, Kevin Wu. You got a Stogue, yo? Yo, you got a Stogue? With a fucking baby blue do-rag on his head. Yo, you got a Stogue, yo? Did you cry yet today? Yeah, Kevin. Did you cry yet today, Kevin? Whoa. Don't cry, brother. They called them Stogues for short. Stogies? All right, take it easy, guys. You guys are still fighting. Kathleen, are you scared? Is this him? It's got to be him. Get the fuck out of here, you fucking weirdo. What's the matter, huh? You got to buy bots and I don't. I have a couple of good shows and all of a sudden you're hopping on my dick. Get the fuck out of here, weirdo. Tom Sheehy, what's up, brother? I'm crying because BK was on the panel. It's all right, Kevin. He's gone now. He's gone. Don't worry about it. Take it easy. Yeah, gee, I wonder who that could be, Lefty. Yeah. Real wise guy. Two great shows back to back. Yeah, you know, I can't take all the credit for it. I got to thank BK and JC and Marky Mark. And, you know, they've been giving me good shows lately. I want to thank Tavin Ace for coming on the show. Lefty, who else? Who do we have on the show lately? We've had some people. Crime Spot's been coming on. He's great. Shout out to Crime Spot. I wonder what, well, I'd like to have Jeff Nadeau on the show so he could talk about this shit, but this whole Merlino situation, that'd be cool, but I don't want to stir the pot there. I'm sure he doesn't have too many nice things to say about the other Jeff. Yeah, get rid of these fucking weirdos, bro. Fucking morons. Yo, Mammy. Now, who talks like that? Maybe I should bring pizza on here just so you can trash the guy. But I won't. I'm just going to continue to ignore that shitbag who's been on my dick for over a fucking year now, fucking weirdo. Off my dick. Sergeant B. Oh, no. Now he's, I think he started a fire in your ass, fat boy. I think Fat Bull Italian's pretty pissed off. I don't know. Hopefully we can resolve it tomorrow. I don't know. We'll see. At least he could be reasoned with, this kid. You could reason with him. You just got to talk it out with him. Yeah, I know. Yeah, J.C., God damn it, Mickey Griggs. God damn it. Someone bounced you? No, Joe Bananas. You're still here. Don't bounce Joe Bananas if he ain't saying nothing crazy. I didn't see him say nothing crazy. Don't do that. Don't do that. Thank you, Dell. I appreciate you, brother. All right, guys. Well, look, I think the show's over. I want to thank you guys for being here. Again, thank you to BK, Anthony Tavanese, Lefty, JC, Marky Mark for coming on the show today. Oh, Casparosa, too. Almost forgot about Casparosa. Shouts to Casparosa. Thank you, brother. And I guess we'll be live tomorrow around the same time. We'll see. Maybe I'll take Saturday off. I don't know. Let me think about this. Yeah. We could do it tomorrow. You never know what you're going to get when you hit live, you know? Anyway. Get him the fuck out of here, this weirdo. Get off my dick and get the fuck out of here. Fucking psychopath. Get a fucking life. 60 years old, lives like an asshole. I mean, just fucking forget about me, bro. I don't even think about you. I mean, I take dumps that got more fucking, that have a life's purpose more than you. Oh, thank you, Tom Sheehy. God knows I need it. I didn't make not one Cash App today. I want to thank the people who did support the channel today. Nightmare, Sven Larson, thank you for popping off the show that way, brother. Thank you so much. Ryan Morrison, my man, I love you, brother. NCO7, shouts to you. Hope your family's doing good. Thank you, NCO7. Gary, my man, the king of the bidets. Thank you, Gary. Marky Mark, shouts to the West Coast. Fuck all these East Coast weenies, man. Fuck these East Coast weenies. Thank you, Marky Mark. You're the fucking man, bro. And Sean, Big Sean, thank you for the $4.99. BK keeping it 100. Yeah, man. Yeah. I don't know. I guess we like BK around here now, huh? That might be a conflict of interest for him. Yeah, I'm going to get mine because, you know, I've done so many horrible things on here, you fucking weirdo. You're going to get yours. You will see. Fuck you. Get him the fuck out of here. Fucking psychopath. My dude. Peace out. Later, Chris. Thank you, Tom. You're the fucking man, bro. All right, guys. Peace out, White Mike. Yeah, it's true, Marky Mark. Yeah, maybe I will start running my mouth about him again. I don't know. We'll see. There's a few things I could say. Be well, Roro. Thank you, sweetheart. Yeah, fuck that freak. That's right, Mickey. Thanks, Tom. Let me check, huh? Let's see what you got going over here. It's like gambling. It's like, oh, my God, what did I get? What did I get? Wow, thank you, brother. That's very generous of you. Thank you, man. That just put a smile on my face. Later, farmer. All right, guys. Stay safe. Stay dangerous. Stay classy. Try to be nice to each other if you can. What did I miss? You missed a great fucking show, Lee. You missed another good one, back to back, 2 days in a row. Good to see you in here, Lee. That's another guy that I have grown to love over the years. We all love Lee Cole here, don't we? Go back to sleep, Lee. Yeah, you missed it, Lee. He was napping. Yeah, Tom, you're the man. Thanks, Tom Sheehy. Lee is cool. Yeah, Lee's a cool dude, man. Lee's definitely a cool dude. It was epic. Yeah, it was epic. It was all right. Yesterday was epic. Lee Cole never sleeps. I don't think he's lying. It'll be like 4 or 5 in the morning and a fucking poll will be up or some sort of community post. And he's got shorts out and he's got shows. And he's got interviews. And so, I don't think he sleeps and he watches baseball. When does he have time to jerk off? I don't know. Nico. See you later, Gary. Thanks again for the support, brother. Oh, Lee's doing real good with the wrestling gig. Lee's doing all right. Everyone is on at the same time. Yeah, well, I'm ending the show. I'm getting out of here. Come on the show tomorrow, Lee, if you can. What's tomorrow? Thursday? It feels like tomorrow's Friday. I don't know. That might conflict with your time. I don't know. I'm going to go live at 4 o'clock tomorrow, Lee. If you want to hop on, I don't know. That'd be cool. I always like to hear from Lee Cole, dude. All right, guys. Don't repeat what you hear here. You hear because a lot of lies were told, and we cleared them up today. So don't repeat what you hear here. Yeah, we like Lee over here. Yeah. All right, guys. Until next time, people. Peace. Oh, somebody's calling me. Yeah. Peace out, y'all.